Ναι, ναι, και κρέμονος βαχώνει και ο Μάικ, το έτσι σου λέει.
Κομ. Into the day with the dawn ringing in my ears. Oh, well, I tune into my TV show. No better way, I gotta get myself into gear. Let's go. Oh, and I feel good today with my wake up in the morning espresso. I feel good today. It's my feel good breakfast show.
Very good morning, you beautiful souls, as we say every day because it's true. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's a Friday. It's a Friday. We'll do our utmost to get you inspired, make it feel like it's the weekend, distract you as you prepare yourself for a very hard-working day to go and be a positive contributor to this incredible country of ours. We'll also inspire you, and it's been that kind of week. It really has been inspirational, entering into pretty much the second half of the year, which is crazy. Things seem to be speeding up as always. I know a lot of people caught in the grips of winter, but it's a massive weekend. Not only do we have the Durban July, of course, locally, but a huge amount of local investment in sport. Bafana up against Egypt tomorrow in the round of 16 in AFCON. I think a couple of weeks ago, we didn't think we'd be talking about that, but a huge amount on the sporting front happening. Jeremy is here to chew through all of that with you as well. And Leanne and myself are very happy to be welcoming a gorgeous new soul into our space as well, just for today. But of course, the most important part of the show is the two-way conversation with you as well. So please let us know how you are feeling this morning. As always, you have a direct line. You can contact us on all of our social media platforms, and we are always listening. We are always watching. At Expresso Show is the handle to use. But the gorgeousness is overloaded this morning, ladies. How are you doing?
We are so good, G-Man. We are so good. It is a gorgeous Friday. And yes, you are right. We're joined by the gorgeousness that is Palesa, baby girl.
Welcome to the show. South Africa. It is so lovely to crack open that first cup of coffee with you along at home with you and Graham. I mean, we're about to have the best Friday ever.
We really are. We've got some great guests on the show. We've got you on the show. You're going to be hanging out with us. It's going to be absolutely awesome. But you know what? We can't do this without you. And as we do every single morning, we throw something out at you on social media. Mm-hmm. And that is what Palesa is going to give us, those that social media question.
So on social media, we have been asking you, what would your ideal getaway be? Ooh. I'm already picturing myself posted up, honey, on a beach somewhere. But let's hear from you at home what you have to say. We've got Palesa here saying, somewhere warm so I can have a picnic. And they use the hashtag morning. Absolutely. We've got Michelle here saying, morning Expresso family. I would love to go to Paris. I would love. Paris is always
weekend,
a good idea.
You know, as like we do.
You know, casually go to Paris. Franklin here says, good morning, folks. Spain would be lovely. I mean, people here have international dreams. I'm just trying to go somewhere where the sun is burning bright. I mean,
that would probably be Europe right now. I mean, they're seeing levels up to 40 degrees. So yeah, maybe you want to stay at home. I'm thinking I want to go anywhere in the bushveld. Yeah. Anywhere that's maybe like a nature reserve. I think that would be absolutely stunning. Campfires at night. I'm available for that. But you know what might inform your weekend getaway ideas is what the weather's looking like. So let's quickly take a look at what is our temperatures in terms of Johannesburg this morning. You're looking at plenty of sunshine with clear skies and little to no wind. Humidity will remain low throughout the day. Temperatures peak midday and decrease towards the evening. Sunny conditions are expected for the weekend. Now moving over to Durban, partly sunny conditions. There will be intervals of clouds and sunshines with nice warm temperatures. Now towards the evening, cloud cover increases with a shower in the area. A southwesterly wind can be expected. And how about you, PE? Good morning. Partly sunny conditions with a light southerly breeze for the duration of the day. Skies will clear up towards the evening as humidity remains steady. Occasional showers are expected over the weekend. And then last but certainly not least, Cape Town. Mainly cloudy conditions with a shower in the area later this afternoon. A light northwesterly breeze throughout the day. As the evening approaches, more showers are expected. Be prepared for rain this weekend. So those weekend ideas is going to be indoors, Cape Town. But it's really, really cool that we do this because Now we know what we should be wearing. It's really great because you could have the best outfit plan, but if the weather's not going to play along.
If it's not on your side, girl, it's not on your side. Exactly. I mean, if you're in Durban and if you're in Johannesburg, definitely have that sunscreen out because it looks like it's going to be a hot one this weekend. Exactly. I'm kind of jelly. I wish I was going home to see everyone, but you know, it's all good,
it's
girl.
It's all good. But let's take a look at what you're wearing today. You are looking absolutely stunning. Both of us are wearing black, but here's the beautiful thing. We're wearing different textures and fabrics. What are you loving most about what you're wearing today?
What I love about it is that it's still super cute, it's super trendy, it's super youthful, but it's also velvet, it's soft, it's warm. I paired it with some lovely stockings and of course a Woolies boot.
You can never
go wrong with a pop of color.
You know that.
It's a little bit, it's cute, it's got some personality to it,
exactly.
But I see that you also kind of changed it up.
I'm
kind of matching
the black as well. So mine's got a little bit of a slit. Both of us are cinched in at the waist, which I love, right? So we're cinching it at the waist and all black. Very, very nice little dress here. I also feel very warm in it because it's a bit of a tight fit.
Yeah.
And then we've both paired it with some lovely gold accessories because black and gold go really well.
But then in terms
of my lip, I always feel like a popping red lip goes so well with a black dress, just like you are using a popping maroon shoe, which goes so well with black as well.
Well, I'm more of a nude kind of girl, so I love a nude lip, but my eyes always make sure that they're popping as well. So I'm liking our vibe today.
I love it.
Kind of looks cute too.
He always looks cute.
A little jersey over him. I see you there.
A little jersey. I mean, it sounds like I'm running around half naked with a little jersey around me. No, loving the look this morning, loving the Friday feels, loving having Palesa in studio, such an awesome energy. So you can show her some love on our social media platforms. But we've been on a trend this week. We've been joining, I suppose, the original free thinker. Obviously, we know his ability to understand massive concepts within science, well documented. We are talking about Albert Einstein, E equals MC squared, the theory of relativity. He's been able to wrap his big old brain around some of the biggest concepts there are, but he was also a humanitarian who focused that attention on us as a species, on our planet and our own evolution. And I absolutely love this quote. And maybe he was a disruptor as well, if that's even a term. Nothing will benefit human health and increase the chances for survival of life on Earth as much as the evolution to a vegetarian diet. Wow. And I've just gone all big protein this week. Now I'm going to have to rethink that again. But maybe it's an opportunity for you to rethink the way that you consume goods, the way that you consume meat, the way that you are a consumer, because you can send a very powerful message to the powers that be with the way that you spend your money, with the way that you live your life. So with those very wise words from Mr. Albert Einstein, let's get a few more wise words from our gorgeous leaders. Let's get into the news.
Well, in your national news this morning, as we go 7 minutes after six, global environmental activist John Barty has offered to pay 1 million rand for the freedom of the Johannesburg Zoo elephants. The Department of Justice and Correctional Services says implementing full body scanners at prisons would assist in combating smuggling. Now moving further abroad, British Gambian Mansata Kurung is aiming to improve the quality of life for an estimated 4 million people across Africa living with dementia by means of a new virtual reality app which can be downloaded to a cell phone. A new species of bee fly in Australia. Paramonovius Night King has been named after the Game of Thrones villain, the Night King, because it thrives in winter, has a crown of spine-like hairs, and turns other insects into zombies. And then finally, people are having a field day on social media after the Ukraine's health minister has suggested that swear words can be good for one's health, as using them can indicate good emotional contact between people. Dr. Ulana Suprin was commenting on a proposed new law being put forward to stop public figures from swearing in the media. The doctor added that people should work on removing their feelings of aggression rather than their obscene language. The politician wondered how Ukraine would be able to talk about life in Ukraine if the anti-swearing law is passed. Others imagined a world where people could swear in dedicated spaces or even introducing swearing rooms in offices. I think those rooms might actually be really popular. Well, that was your first look at what's happening in the world of news. Here's a look at what's happening in the world of sport with Graham.
Well, Jeremy Harris is here to chew through the meat of our sport coming up over the weekend. We thought we'd track some of those more interesting headlines that are breaking this morning. In the world of tennis, this certainly got our attention. Tennis greats Rafa Nadal and Roger Federer, of course, doing battle in Wimbledon as we speak, not with each other, but they will be making their way to Cape Town in 2020, where they will attempt to set a new world record for the most attendees at a tennis match, and that'll be held at Cape Town Stadium. Then in the world of football, English Premier League club Chelsea have appointed former midfielder and superstar Frank Lampard as their new manager on a 3-year deal. That was after coach Maurizio Sarri left the club to take charge of Italian champions Juventus. Then on the Cricket World Cup watch, West Indies, they've claimed their second win in the ICC Cricket World Cup. It was after beating bottom of the table Afghanistan, who put in a spirited performance for that by 23 runs in Leeds last night. And of course, needing a result to go their way, New Zealand will be watching the match between Pakistan and Bangladesh. Of course, a final spot in the semi-finals up for grabs. 11:30 South African time is when that match kicks off. And that's where we leave our sport for now. We'll delve into our weekend highlights in just a moment. As always, we are hugely appreciative of your sunrise pictures. We've asked you to send through some breathtaking vistas, and John Lineker sent us this beautiful multicolored skyline from Bloemfontein. John, thank you so much. This is what you can expect in your part of the world. Sunny to partly cloudy conditions with little to no wind, reaching a maximum of just 18 degrees. Casting a wider net, Polokwane, your low 6 going up to 23 degrees, your highest temperature in the country. It is in Mbombela, 7 degrees, your low going up to 29 degrees. Pretoria, your low 4 going up to 22. Clear skies for Johannesburg, but with a chilly start, 2 degrees, your minimum going up to just 19. Mahikeng, ranging between 3 and 23. Then a cold start to the morning for Klerksdorp, minus 1, but going up to a moderate 20 degrees. Kimberley between 0 and 18 degrees. Then the lowest temp in the country today, nice and early in Bloem, minus 4 degrees. 18 degrees is your high. Richards Bay, 11 and 22 your range for the day, with a bit of rain expected. Pietermaritzburg, 7 your minimum, going up to a max of 19. Then a southwesterly wind of 30 kilometers an hour expected there. Durbs ranging between 13 and 21 degrees. Mthatha, 0 and 16. And a couple of showers expected for East London. 8 your low, going up to 18 degrees. Paddock, 0 is where you start, going up to a chilly 14 degrees, and a high humidity in Port Elizabeth ranging between 8 and 17 degrees today. George, your low 8 going up to a high of 16. Sutherland, 2 degrees going up to a max of 12 degrees. Cape Town in the mother city ranging between 11 and 17 degrees with a bit of cloud cover. Worcester, your low 8 going up to 18 degrees. Springbok ranging between 4 and 20 degrees, and Upington, 2 degrees your low, going up to a nice sunny 21 degrees. But if that hasn't warmed you up, maybe a little spicy entertainment news will.
Well, it's time for us to get into the entertainment news. Palesa joining us all morning, and we're so super excited. It's going to be an incredible Friday.
Yeah.
So we're about 2 weeks away from one of the biggest CGI live action remakes of an animation that we all grew up with. 25 years ago, yeah, we were introduced to The Lion King, and now it is going to be a live-action remake opening in South Africa on the 19th of July. Cannot wait for it. But we have even more amazing news.
Yeah, my goodness.
Exactly. So we haven't even heard that opening sequence, you know, that voice. That one. Yes, honey. From the anticipated upcoming The Lion King live-action CGI remake coming out in 2 weeks. And we are already getting a glimpse into what the Factory of Dreams, otherwise known as Walt Disney Pictures, yeah, is concocting next. Now, we've been aware for quite a while that Disney's golden renaissance from the tail end of the past millennium is the smash 1989 movie, that nautical adventure known as The Little Mermaid, was announced that they're going to be doing the same thing. And yeah, now we know that 19-year-old singer Halle Bailey, who is part of the contemporary R&B sister duo, Chloe and Halle, has been cast as the new Ariel.
I love her. I am so obsessed with these sisters. But even more that Halle is now going to play Ariel.
Come on.
I mean, we're so used to Ariel having those gorgeous red locks, but now homegirl has switched
Hello.
It up. She was just
I love it. So director Rob Marshall said in a statement that the young singer possesses that rare combination of spirit, heart, youth, innocence, and substance, plus a glorious singing voice, all intrinsic qualities necessary to play this iconic role. The singer, who along with her sister Chloe is signed under singing sensation Beyonce's management company, Parkwood Entertainment, who incidentally is going to be playing Nala in The Lion King, has also got vast experience, having opened for Beyonce's last three world tours, as well as acting in the spin-off for the widely loved comedy Black-ish and Grown-ish. Now, the youngster has expressed her excitement for the role, posting that the famous frame of Ariel singing on a rock on Twitter with a caption, "Dream come true," except the Ariel in the picture has dark hair and skin. Melanin popping!
And I'm here for it!
Oh, and of course, confirmed castmate so far is, and I met him, he's the cutest little boy, Jacob Tremblay. He's so stunning. The young child star from the critically acclaimed film The Room, who will voice Ariel's fishy bestie Flounder, and of course comedian from Crazy Rich Asians is also going to be Scuttle, so that's going to be quite awesome. I can't wait. I think we are so blessed. We have had the best year of movies. People have been pushing the boundaries, so I cannot wait to see Ariel come to life.
Absolutely. I mean, I always say that I am a Disney child.
Yeah.
Graham, come on in.
Hey.
Don't be stingy with that coffee. You know, this
you
is kind of
too
rare for me.
I'm so excited about you being
here, I just want to know who's going to play Ursula.
That I made myself 3 cups of coffee just to kind of jumpstart. No, it's just for you, sweetheart. I'm just a little crab man. I'm just a little crab man.
Do you know what? He's never done this.
What?
Really? He's never done this
before.
Oh, well,
cheers, Graham. Thank you so much. I feel super special.
Good. That's the last cup of coffee I'm going to make you today.
Look, I hear Ursula is actually going to be played by McCarthy. Melissa McCarthy, looking forward to that.
Oh, my goodness. Please say that when JP Sebastian walks in, I'm just a little crab man.
Okay. Oh, okay. And Adasi.
Enjoy a moment in between with McAfee. See you after the break.
Cadbury Dairy Milk shines a light on the generosity alive in each of us. Bring your old toys to any of the Cadbury Dairy Milk's pop-up little generosity shops in major centres this winter and receive a slab of Cadbury Dairy Milk chocolate. Get to Durban's Gateway Mall Little Generosity Shop from the 25th of June until the 8th of July with your toys, and let's inspire a little more Cadbury Dairy Milk goodness in the world.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for tuning in. You're live with Expresso. My name is Graham Richards, and it is a sports weekend par excellence. Massive final, starting with the Super Rugby final, lest we forget, where the Crusaders face the Jaguares. On paper, the Crusaders should walk away with this one, but the Argentinian outfit have just been superb this year, and they could cause the upset of the year. It'll feel like a final win by Botswana take on Egypt in their AFCON round of 16 clash. We've seen it before on the continent. We can do it. Can they get past the mighty hosts with Mo Salah in the mix? We just don't know. And then finally, of course, we preview the FIFA Women's World Cup final. What an exhibition of football that tournament has given us. I'm sure someone who is relishing, basking in the glory of the sport at the moment, sports anchor and good mate Jeremy Harris is with us today. You always make me feel so good in this, let's be honest, rather negative sporting landscape that we've had to traverse. And we will get onto the cricket a little bit later. I mean, to say negative and cricket in the same sentence, but exciting times. Would have been better to have a South African team in
somewhere.
And as I said, it's almost like, Graham, just let it go, man, let it go. But what an opportunity to get excited about a final. Why? Because it's not an all New Zealand final. And we have got probably, I don't know which it will be. That's how I feel about this match. The only team that could disrupt the Crusaders.
Got to agree.
How do you see this one playing out?
I agree. I mean, I think firstly, look, let's pay homage to the Crusaders. Two in a row, and they're coming into hopefully three in a row. So that'll be their plan. But and when you talk about home stadiums, home venues being a fortress, they were describing.
Have they been beaten there? When last were they beaten?
Well, in a final goes back to what, 2015. I mean, it's a while back. But I mean, the last two has been all them as they've beaten the South African Lions in the last two finals. But I mean, I think if there's going to be one team that's going to do the damage, it's going to be the Jaguares. And I think that they will go there not impressed by anybody, knowing exactly what their game plan is, and they will go hard at the New Zealanders.
They've a perfect World Cup trajectory. That's where Argentina has been.
Yes.
They've used every one of the tools that Super Rugby has presented them to build a core of leadership, some fantastic players that are playing well, but also have that leadership core. But they know how to slow down the breakdown like an Australian team. They know how to break the line with big forwards that can also pass the ball like a backline player now, very much like a New Zealand outfit. What has it been about that team that has clicked this year that has allowed them to perform? When you consider where they were 3-4 years ago, the Whipping Boys.
Yeah, no, but I think you're exactly right. What's happened is that over those 3-4 years that we've seen is that they spent a lot of time together. They've grown to know each other's games very well. And you know, eventually you click as a team, as a unit.
I believe.
And the nice thing is that there's been consistency amongst the personnel. So the guys have been going, sure, we've lost, but we know, just tweak that little thing and this little thing. And so eventually you're going to click. You're going to be able to hold your own in the top flight. And we're seeing that not only, you know, in Super Rugby, but we're seeing it in international rugby as well.
So moving swiftly on, Bafana, up against Mo Salah. We joke about that because Mo is just awe-inspiring.
Yeah.
But bearing in mind, most of his achievements in the modern era, in this time that we have loved him, have been achieved at the front of an unbelievable Liverpool team. Is this the Egypt side, when we talk about like an Al Ahly being beaten 5-0 by
Sundowns,
which did happen, it did actually happen.
Just the other day,
with a lot of the same personnel on that field. I mean, I honestly believe, I feel positive about where Bafana are going, that if they can get the right balance of the best parts of what we've seen in the three matches thus far, they can do something special. We held one of the best teams in the tournament up until the 90th minute.
Yeah.
How's this going to play out?
Graham, I mean, it's interesting. It's almost ironic that these two teams, Bafana and Egypt, are probably the most criticized teams in terms of their sort of defensive mindset. That, you know, everybody's saying, well, the Egyptians are too defensive, even though they've won, but they've been very defensive minded. South Africa as well. But I mean, to your point, Al Ahly going down 5-0 to Sundowns is a little bit of a mini sort of indicator of what South Africa can do. They're there, they're able to score goals, they just haven't. And so they're going to have to decide, you know, are we going to go there and sit, you know, in our own goal area, or are we going to, you know, put the ball over and put it into the net?
And I just felt with Percy on the right there, they were creating chances, they were creating space.
Yeah, and they were holding their own. They definitely were.
No, completely. Very. I mean, I've got to pay homage to the quality of women's football at the moment has been awe-inspiring to watch in the FIFA Women's World Cup. The final, of course, the United States, who are just insanely good, up against the Netherlands, who are just insanely good.
Yeah.
You would have to give it to the United States on paper?
Yeah, I would give it to them on paper. I'm probably going to have to give it to them on the field as well, because I think that they've just got so much firepower.
They did to England within the first 30 seconds, you could just feel the sweat beating on your own forehead.
But the pressure that they were under, you know, parts of the game, they just weathered the storm, you know, were able to come back with the win. So I'm going to say that it's probably going to be the USA to pick up the trophy on, you know, on Sunday evening, but certainly the Netherlands will go in there not prepared to make up the numbers. They will go in there knowing what they've done to get to the final. And I mean, you know, it's one game of football.
Anything finals are final, yo. Yeah. Finals are final. So we are relishing having all of this beautiful sport to delve into, and we'd love to hear from you as we broach the ICC Cricket World Cup. Of course, getting crunch time there. Not so much for South Africa, who take on Australia. Can we dent their pride just a little bit, or will we be that final piece in the puzzle at season peak at just the right time? We'll delve into that after the break.
Get to a crazy store in your town this school holiday and discover a treasure trove of arts and crafts for the whole family to enjoy, as always, at great value. Paper, paints, modeling clay, sketchbooks, glitter, crayons, aprons, rubber stamps, ribbons, felt-tip pens, learn-to-paint sets, and a whole universe of creative fun at crazy good value. Only at the Crazy Store. Holidaying near or far, there'll be one just about wherever you are.
Put a smile on my face, you were my ride, get out, but like a little boy, I got a bash of a shed. The only thing that I want, you when I fail, you can't know when, forever and ever. Don't worry what they talk about you, I know that they wish they were you. Don't worry what they think about you, worry about me and you. Yeah, what we doing next? Now we moving, are we moving, where we going next? It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Yes, welcome back. You're live with Expresso. Not only does that music inspire you to do the robot, you know it means only one thing. Time for our Tech Daily Update. And what an exciting tech talk we have in store for you today. Millions, billions maybe, of people around the world were unable to use their favorite social media services, Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp for up to 9 hours on Wednesday. Ah, the shock. I know there's some real post-traumatic stress going about as we speak. But here to unpack exactly what went on is our friend in tech, Brian Smith. Brian, welcome back, buddy.
Thank you very much.
What's
Thank
up,
you.
Brian? Thanks okay, me. Let's be honest. There were a lot of people that weren't models anymore, okay? Yeah. So a few people were out of a job for 9 hours.
There were a lot of Instagram feeds that just didn't make it that day.
But now they're back. What exactly caused the outage?
So that's a particularly interesting question. It's now one of a number of different outages that Facebook and its associated services have had over the past couple of months. Facebook actually hasn't officially clarified what the specific cause of this outage is. However, the most common theory on the street, so to speak, is that it actually had an outage with to do with one of its DNS providers. That's essentially a service that will link up the IP address of a website to its name, being facebook.com.
Okay. Yeah.
And principally, the outage that is expected that failed essentially was one that handled all of its image services across not only Facebook, but also WhatsApp and then Instagram as well.
Because these all bleed into each other. So
it's all within the same stable now. And unfortunately, what that means is when you have one point of failure, the rest of the services all go down. And that's particularly damaging for a service like Instagram, of course, that is particularly driven by images.
Exactly.
Yeah. So you're saying like a 12-year-old Russian hacker? That's what you're saying. That's what
we don't know that yet. That's what anything's possible.
I think a lot of people who cared were taken aback by the rather strange kind of image information things. It felt like we were getting an inside view that maybe we weren't supposed to be getting.
And perhaps one that we're not ready for. Yeah. So this actually was incredibly interesting in that given that images weren't showing on Facebook, what a number of users reported seeing is seeing instead what's called alternate text, so image that would appear in, text that would appear in place of an image.
Okay.
And what they reported seeing was actually an artificial intelligence system trying to classify what you might have seen in that image in its place.
Wow.
So for example, it might have said male potentially with beard, or if it was a pet, it might have identified you had a dog, what breed, what cat. And that's something that we actually haven't heard from Facebook is an official feature thus far. We obviously know it uses artificial intelligence to tag your photos of friends and family, for example. But what we didn't know is that it can actually categorize precisely what's in your image with such a degree of accuracy.
Yeah.
And it's a really interesting look behind what can be called the iron curtain of Facebook.
Yeah. Well, I think the important question is, how does one know when this will happen again in the future?
So that's sort of the big question in the room, right? If we consider it's not just Facebook we have to worry about, there are a variety of online services we might use, and then we might even have our own websites or media that we need to worry about whether it's up or down. Fortunately, there are a number of online tools that we can actually use to track just this perfect. Perhaps the most prolific one is one called Down Detector, which will essentially provide a monitoring list of all local services, but also international ones that you can use to track whether it's actually working or not.
Yeah.
So you just got to use data and like MMS someone. How do you get a picture to someone?
Yeah. True story.
Yeah, but I mean, I know I make light of it, but a lot of people are influencers earning their money from that companies that do exist purely in that social media space. So the repercussions can be massive. 9 hours of productivity lost is a big, big slice. Really interesting stuff. Brian,
thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Brian. Of course, that is our wrap of tech news for today. The world of tech news, never a dull moment. Ooh.
You know how they were saying people were losing their minds? I'm people, Graham and Leanne. I am people. Now warm up your fingers and get ready to get crafty with Graham and the Crazy Store this morning. If you're looking for ways to keep the kids entertained the last stretch of the school holidays, well, the Crazy Store says embrace your creative side with an artist and arts craft filled day, courtesy of the crazy good range and artsy stuff and good ideas.
Big or small, we've got it all. Everyone will find something at the Crazy Store. It's no wonder South Africa considers the Crazy Store the crazy fun place to shop.
When kids are home for the holidays, they are bound to get bored and a little restless at some point. So why not keep them active, occupied, and creative with some totally awesome holiday craft ideas? Something they can do on their own or with a little help from mom and dad. Thanks to our friends at the Crazy Store, because hey, you never know what you might find. From painting on wet glue to create spectacular effects to creating our own slime, we've got you covered. And the best part, it's all really simple. To get started, pour a generous amount of white glue onto your lid and swirl it around to cover the entire surface area. Have your child put one or two drops of each color of paint around the glue. Then give your child a toothpick to swirl the colors around in the glue. Stop swirling before the colors get too combined or the final result will be muddy and brown. For younger kids, using the toothpick to swirl helps develop their fine motor skills as well. Let it dry, and as the colors expand, they create this awesome, almost tie-dyed psychedelic effect. So cool. While you're waiting for your paint glue artwork to dry, you can get a little bit slimy. By following these step-by-step instructions, you can learn how to create your very own slime, thanks to the Crazy Store. Step one, add 40 mils of water into a cup. Step two, add 5 grams of slime powder into the cup. Step three, mix the water and slime powder with the stick until fully blended. Step four, 5 minutes later, your own slime is finished. Keeping active kids entertained throughout the entire school holidays is not for the faint-hearted, and it's easy to start feeling like every second of every minute should be jam-packed full of activity. But sometimes, simply sitting down and creating something imaginative can be even more satisfying. So make sure you follow the Crazy Store on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter to check out and learn all about their new products and the insanely fun and awesome ways that you can use them.
With the Crazy Store in just about any town near you. Have fun crafting during the school holidays and make sure that you follow the Crazy Store on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter to learn more about their exciting new products and fun ways that you can join and use them with Graham, just like he did this morning.
Exactly. Never a dull moment with the Crazy Store, but the show is going to be pretty crazy today because it's not a Friday, it's a Fri-yay. And joining us in the studio and a lady that we get to catch up with after the break is Fifi Cooper!
One of my favorites!
After the break.
Get to a Crazy Store in your town this school holiday and discover a treasure trove of arts and crafts for the whole family to enjoy, as always, at great value. Paper, paints, modeling clay, sketchbooks, glitter, crayons, aprons, rubber stamps, ribbons, felt-tip pens, learn to paint sets, and a whole universe of creative fun at crazy good value. Only at the Crazy Store. Holidaying near or far, there'll be one just about wherever you are.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. It's a gorgeous Friday, and you know what? Nothing takes a Friday to that next level than with some great music. And here this morning, we've got a performer that is famously known as the First Lady of Motswako, as well as the boss lady of Mo Cooper Records. I'm talking about multi-award-winning artist and songstress, Fifi Cooper, everybody! In the house. Fifi, I am so jealous. I want. You look gorgeous.
Thank you so much.
Welcome to the show.
I feel that's the same WhatsApp girl.
Almost. Yeah, me and you, almost.
I mean, Fifi Cooper, you are an incredible powerhouse in the entertainment industry.
Thank you.
I won't even say in the music industry, just entertainment in general, because so many people can learn and grow from your journey. And take me through that journey. I mean, you went from being the first female rapper to ever release an album in South Africa.
Yes,
and then in the, 2016 Metro FM Awards, you pretty much walked away with everything.
You cleaned house.
How did that look for you? How do you feel? Do you believe that it's real? Are you, is this even real?
I don't know. You know, what's weird for me is that in the beginning, for me, it wasn't about the money. It was about, you know, the passion, the dream, and, you know, the talent that I have. And, you know, moving to Joburg was really crazy for me because that's when things started happening for me. I got signed, and, you know, literally my first album, the love that I was getting, not only from South Africa, but around the world, because we did have a UK tour, it was absolutely incredible. And you know, for me, every single day is like a reminder that I am really blessed, you know, so I am really happy to have fans who, you know, are always supporting me. So it's just like I'm taking it one step at a time, and only from here, we're going all the way to the top.
Well, girl, we're taking notes, trust me.
You are famously known as the First Lady of Motswako, representing Muffy King, by the way.
Yes,
hello.
Ma'am.
But you know what? I think that we don't want to put you in a box as a female rapper. You are a rapper.
Yes.
What does it mean to you to be making such a name for yourself and to be dominating in what was previously such a male-driven industry?
I think for me, all the time, I always tell myself that I have to lead, especially for the, you know, coming generation. So I'm not afraid to take risks.
Yes.
That's why now I'm also venturing into being an entrepreneur, because it's one of the main things of being an entrepreneur. First of all, you can't be afraid to take risks. So for me, I always want to, you know, prove to the young generations, like our previous legends did, you know, Abu Brenda Fassie and Lebo, you know, me growing up, they inspired me because, you know, they were not scared to go out there and do what they do and really be who they really are.
Yeah.
So that's exactly what I'm trying to do, and just, you know, focus on like building the brand Fifi and just show the youngins that, you know, you do have something and just follow your dreams.
I love that, taking risks. You know, so many dreams have died because people were afraid of taking that leap of faith, and I'm so glad that you put it out there. You have nothing to lose, but you have everything to gain.
Yes, ma'am.
This is so beautiful. I mean, having this conversation with you just inspires me so, so much. But you're with us throughout the show. You're going to be dropping some incredible bars. So I'm looking forward to your performances.
Thank you so much.
So it's time now to find out if a sequel, an animated sequel, can stand up. Let's see who the heavy hitters are in the South African box office.
Furry friends, devilish dolls, and other nostalgic flicks. This week's box office top five has it all. Annabelle Comes Home. Most South Africans stayed home. It's fifth. All the Agents and Aliens in its star-studded galaxy couldn't get MIB International off the ground. It's fourth. But like a shooting star, it's come so far. Aladdin's riding high in week six at three. Including Toy Story 4 means we're all 90s kids now. This time machine's superb and second. And all of SA's cat ladies and good boys flock to see The Secret Life of Pets 2 to first.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Now, just imagine a world, Mr. JP Sebastian, where it wasn't the Beatles singing that iconic song, but someone else, some random guy who was a failure in music.
Absolutely, thank you. Two failures in music.
But it was so cool to see you. JP Sebastian, he's just a little crab, man. Anarasi. So moving
we're living my primary school years, yes, Sebastian the Crab.
I'm sorry, I couldn't resist, man. Two awesome movies we're going to focus on this morning. One on the lighter notes. I've seen a lot of press about this. It looks phenomenal. So give us the premise here. Describe Yesterday for us, please.
Himesh Patel is the actor who wakes up in a world, I think that he has a concussion or something like that.
This one does.
Something goes sideways and comes back to a world where he's the only person who remembers every single Beatles song ever written. And every time he's like, wait, Graham, come on, you remember this, right?
Yesterday.
Like the other person absolutely does not know what he's talking about. They're off the radar. But they think
have you heard of the Beatles? Like Beatles. Like
they think that the dude is basically a genius in this world
as
that he's woken up
were.
In. Yeah, or even though it's set in present day, but I suppose even in present day, people still listen to their music. Are you a big Beatles fan, by the way?
My mom really has imparted that love of the music, the genre, and what they did for music as well.
So. One song that stands out for you?
You know, everyone goes to Imagine, but that seems like more John Lennon than the Beatles for me. Yeah. But I would probably say Yesterday, believe it or not, it's probably the most iconic for me. One of those entry levels.
I'm sorry, I put you
Yellow
on the spot.
Yellow Submarine, maybe, is, but that kind of speaks to a younger time of my life. I don't know. Every single song of theirs
the
is 60s. Awesome.
A younger
but
time.
I mean, like, the enjoyment of the song, you know?
How the movie, in a way, tries to reapproach that first feeling of enjoyment, the first time anyone was exposed to the Beatles, irrespective of their age, is that it's quite a clever mechanic. Imagine that they were re-injected into the world by a completely random dude, which the Beatles were in the small town of Liverpool back in the day. And then he has to deal with the chaos of becoming, like, popularity skyrocketing, because he was a struggling musician before he, like...
Failure, yeah.
comes upon this revelation, and so he's got that to deal with, and also Lily James. Tell me I got the name right. It's Lily James.
Lily James,
yes,
yeah.
Yes. She was obviously in the last movie, the ABBA movie. I forgot the name. What's the
ABBA? I know what you mean. Yeah.
Right, you know the one. So she's got a beautiful singing voice as well that she puts in some of the work, but Himesh Patel, he plays guitar and also sings in this movie, and he seems to do very, very well himself. Danny Boyle is the director, the dude who did Slumdog Millionaire, so super schmaltzy.
And, yeah,
and I think if you're still in the mood after it is Bohemian Rhapsody, after Rocket Man, then wasn't too long before they made a Beatles thing, was it?
Yeah, I like the take that they've given you, but just from what I've seen, looks absolutely amazing.
Mamma Mia was the movie.
Mamma Mia, there we go, Mamma Mia, Mamma Mia, okay. Greta. I find it difficult to believe that Chloe Grace Moretz can be victimized by anyone. She's so hardcore and so awesome, but this looks freaky.
And good for her, I was just saying to you now, as well as that she's such a young actress and she's taking these small roles that are challenging and interesting rather than falling into the superhero circuit or some sort of a young adult romance movie, which is easy big bucks.
I'm sure being pushed, yeah.
But tiny stuff, I mean, this is after the Miseducation of Cameron Post, which was apparently amazing. But Greta is about Isabelle Huppert, who was an Oscar nominee in 2017 for Elle. In this, she plays a solitary, keeps to herself, a senior lady in New York City, and gradually you find out why, because Chloe Grace Moretz finds an abandoned handbag on the subway one day, and that's the good Samaritan she is, because she's an out-of-town girl, not a New Yorker who's like, how much could I sell this for? She goes looking for the owner of the bag, finds, as you're looking at in the scene we're presently showing you, a cabinet filled with bags, and that she has been lured into a bit of
Are you allowed to transfer your skills from one movie into another? Can't you use Kung Fu in this movie to save yourself?
There are so many times in Greta where I was like, why aren't you going ham on her face? Why aren't you breaking handbags over her head?
Double spinning, jumping back kick, come on!
No, so it's very interesting because, I mean, aside from, you know, giving yourself diverse characters once in a while, if you want to talk about these kinds of relationships where people are manipulated by people who are like, but I'm lonely, you need to be my friend, you need to stay my friend, and being gaslit and stuff like that, it's a real thing that, you know, you can't blame an abuser, someone who is abused for maybe not defending themselves or something like that. So it does actually come across in a way that's not unreasonable that she should be as meek and stuck as she looks as a character. So anyway, I watched it. It was pretty good for I suppose a forgettable kind of thriller experience.
You don't look traumatized, man.
Well, hey, it made me think again, and I think we all should, about deleting Facebook, maybe, because stalkers.
Ooh, well, Facebook might be deleting itself. We're going to delve a little bit further into what's happening at the box office. Spider-Man Far From Home looks absolutely awesome. We'll find out how many
popcorns. Is that how you fire web?
Yeah, we'll find out how many popcorns a little bit later.
Oh, how about that Greta movie, huh? Oh, when I first saw it, I was like, meh. And then I was just but wait a minute. Would you go and watch that, Phoebe?
I think I would. I'm a fan of movies, so if there's a new movie out there, I'll definitely, you know, go out and, like, see what's happening.
Nice. I actually went to watch Spider-Man Far From Home last night, but I watched it in 4DX. Needless to say, I need a massage, man.
That ducking and...
But it was so amazing. So many great movies on the circuit right now, so definitely go and check it out.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Happy birthday, a very happy birthday to you.
Let's feel it in your bones, feel it in your soul. It's your birthday, you deserve to feel special. Hopefully, we will be making you feel extra special today. Vanessa, this is the first time you are donning the extra awesome little unicorn hat.
And I feel like I take on birthday superpowers as soon as
you are now like 5'3".
That's
so mean.
You shady
look awesome.
Lady.
You look awesome.
Are you heightist?
I am a bit of a heightist.
Okay. All right.
Someone asked me yesterday how tall you are. I'm like, I'm almost 6 foot. So you're not 6 foot. So, you're five.
Yeah,
I'm like,
Boom.
So we love you. We love your birthdays. We love being able to be a part of your special day. So we're going to try and get through as many of our viewers as possible by the looks of it. We've got a ton of birthdays. Do you want to kick us off?
I'll kick it off for us. Yeah. Mershinal. Now, we have a birthday wish that reads, I want to wish my sister a very happy birthday. I want to thank God for you adding another year to your life. May God continue blessing your beautiful soul. Mm. And may he grant you all of your heart's desires on this special day with lots of love from your sister. Guys, have you seen the gorgeous girl that's on screen right now?
She's so cool.
That's a camera blocking her view.
Stunning!
Eyelashes on fleek.
4 days. Ooh, also, the next birthday wish goes to Vincent. A very happy and blessed 56th birthday. This comes with lots of love from your wife, Sandra, and your daughter, Alison.
You
happy
look
birthday, Vincent.
Yeah.
Looking good.
Very dapper, Vincent. We've got our very next birthday shout out here to John Ross Marnie. Oh,
please.
It says John Ross is turning 2 years old today. Happy 2 year old two-year birthday. JR, we love you from mommy and daddy. Oh, happy birthday, John Ross.
Such cuteness.
And then we've got Winchell here. Happy 17th birthday. birthday to Winchell. May God bless you with the fruits of the spirits, love, patience, and happiness. Oh, love from mom, dad, Tamsin, and Andrea. Happy birthday!
Happy birthday. Winchell. Then we'd like to wish Pila Sunday Dlamini a happy 16th birthday. That's a big one. Sweet 16 from her aunt, Nkululeko Dlamini. Happy birthday, Pila Sunday. Yes. And then we move on to a very big happy birthday to our son, Fagan Croats. Know that whatever you choose to do in life, we will forever be proud of you. I am especially proud this year on your birthday that you are becoming a smart, kind, and thoughtful young man. We love you. That's from your mommy, your daddy, Caden and Gran. Happy birthday, man.
I love that.
Beautiful. Like a talented dude.
Well, also turning 2 years old today is Sibatle Nkosi, turning two. How cute. Today you brought so much happiness into our house. We love you so much from your granny and the whole family. Sibatle, happy birthday. And also, Sarah Dean Bezedenoot is turning 11 years old today. Baie geluk met jou verjaarsdag, Shade. God segens op jou lewe van Mama Wendy. Happy birthday.
So I'm going to act like I understood that. Happy birthday to you, Sarah. We've got... We have got...
Marie Jagers. Happy birthday to Marie Jagers. Also turning 13 today. God's richest blessings on your life from mom, from dad, and from brother Justin.
You are a teenager now. Hey.
I remember when I became a teenager, I felt like I was the biggest person ever. So happy birthday goes out to you. We've got our last one here to Julia Fell. Then lastly, we'd love to give a massive...
Huge.
Shout out to our social media manager, Julia Fell, who's also celebrating her birthday today. Happy birthday, Julia. May this year be filled with love and laughter, and may all your wishes come true. Happy birthday to you.
I've never heard that before.
Yeah, that's a different variation.
You're going to fit right in here. We absolutely love it.
I'm already feeling at home.
Oh, man, we love that you guys share these special moments with us. Keep those dedications coming. Please send through a video. Maybe you want to give your own take on happy birthday. Just like that. Send that video to 071-640-6551 on WhatsApp or birthdays@conover.tv. We'd love to hear from you.
Exactly. And before we take a young little break, coming up after this, we are going to be catching up with one of the most incredible performers in South Africa. In fact, we're going to go to it right now.
Yep.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is the moment you've all been waiting for. Make some noise for Fifi Cooper.
Yeah.
Hey, Nadumelanke. Nadumelanke. Hey. Shout out to Tapsi. Boss Lady. I'm feeling so high, nothing dizzy more here. Nothing dizzy more here. Yeah, I live for you, pray for you. My ride or die, I would even take a bullet for you. The future is you. I don't know if I can imagine this life without you. Damn right, you put a smile on my face. You were my ride, kitata kawen. But like a lady, born again, kapasha bashem. The only thing that I want, yeah, when I fail. Jukin ala when, I forever and ever. Don't worry what they talk about you. I know that they wish they were you. Don't worry what they think about you. Worry about me and you. Yeah, what we doing next? Now we moving, are we moving? Where we going next? Yeah, I rap again at 2 man, kako wet. And celebrate that love, yeah, we the best. Ikandang and tizi yo yami yuke. Hey, ikabanga kawe magoga exam. Hey, give all my song, ikbone ma pupeni. Ami, I'm feeling so high, nothing dizzy more. Nothing dizzy more. I like how you call me your wife. Oh, you know you're my baby. Communication is the key to my apartment. Cause loyalty is the reason why we got here. I really hope you want me like I want you. Babe, I really hope you love me like I love you.
If you in it to win it, then maybe we'll win it. I will treat you right and respect you. You deserve to be treated like a kid. You're out here and you're rolling with the queen. What's got my eyes? All eyes on me. Oh, babe, what you get is what you see, huh? Huh? But you know you can get it anytime you want. Oh, come and get it. Once you get it, you better put a ring on it. And once you hit it, you better put a ring on it.
I'm feeling so high, nothing dizzy, boy. Nothing dizzy, boy.
Fifi Cooper on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. As we go 1 minute after seven, here's your national news. Global environmental activist John Varty has offered to pay 1 million rand for the freedom of the Johannesburg Zoo elephants. The Department of Justice and Correctional Services says implementing full body scanners at prisons would assist in combating smuggling. On the international front, British Gambian Mansata Kurung is aiming to improve the quality of life for an estimated 4 million people across Africa living with dementia by means of a new virtual reality app which can be downloaded to a cell phone. A new species of bee fly in Australia, Paramonovius Night King, has been named after Game of Thrones villain, the Night King, because it thrives in winter, has a crown of spine-like hairs, and turns other insects into zombies. And then finally, as Mandela Month kicks off, the Boikanyo Foundation has started an intercontinental initiative to raise funds for children with congenital heart disease. The foundation has partnered with the Nelson Mandela Children's Hospital in Parktown, Johannesburg, to assist critical cases in need of surgery. Cardiothoracic surgeon Dr. Kruben Naidu says some 11,000 children in South Africa alone are born with this condition. Only a quarter will get cardiology. A congenital heart defect is a curable disease, but many children on government waiting lists are not receiving the costly surgery timeously. The team will leave South Africa for Romania on July the 14th in a VW Beetle and will trek through 12 countries before arriving in Romania. What an incredible feat indeed. Well, let's get another look at what's happening in the world of sport. Here's Graham.
Tracking some of those tennis headlines that have making waves at the moment, tennis greats Rafa Nadal and Roger Federer will make their way to Cape Town in 2020, where they will attempt to get a new world record for the most attendees at a tennis match. That will be held at Cape Town Stadium. Then on the footballing front, English Premier League club Chelsea have appointed former midfielder Frank Lampard as their new manager on a 3-year deal. That was after coach Maurizio Sarri left the club to take charge of Italian champions Juventus. And in the Cricket World Cup, the West Indies, they did claim their second win in the ICC Cricket World Cup 2019. That was after beating bottom of the table Afghanistan by 23 runs in Leeds last night. Today, we know New Zealand will be watching the encounter between Pakistan and Bangladesh very closely. That's up for grabs is the final spot in the semi-finals. That match kicking off at 11:30 South African time. We're going to delve into South Africa's final match in the ICC Cricket World Cup. Jeremy joins me for that. Of course, up against Australia in just a moment. Let's see how the roads are looking in your neck of the woods. Gauteng in Pretoria, there is congestion on the R21 southbound. That's between Fountain Circle and Monument Park. Please be patient on the roads this morning. And then in the Western Cape in Mowbray on the N2 inbound, there is a stationary bus before Mowbray Main Road obstructing the ramp lane. Delays can be expected towards Hospital Bend. We know it gets rough there in the morning anyway. Metro Rail on the Northern Line, there is an extended travel time of 30 to 40 minutes on the Wellington Line. online. That's due to TFR signalling restrictions between Belleville and Brackenfell's infrastructure problems in various areas as well. So, and that sets out of service and signal equipment problems. So we really do empathise and apologise, but that's what's going down on the roads and rail.
Don't fear the flu. Boost your immune system with Effaflu C Immune Booster by Pharmadynamics. Effective, affordable healthcare.
So we've asked you to send in your sunrise pictures. Fatah Khan sent us this spectacular sunrise picture from Richards Bay, where partly sunny conditions can be expected with a couple of showers and a light southwesterly wind reaching a maximum of 22 degrees. Let's take a look at the other temperatures. Polokwane, you're looking at a low of 6, rising to 23 degrees today. The highest temperature in the country is in Mbombela, 7, rising to 29 degrees with sunny conditions. Pretoria, your low is 4, reaching 22. Clear skies for Johannesburg, a low of 2, rising to 19. Mahikeng, 3.23, as well as a cold start for the morning in Klerksdorp, minus 1, reaching 20 degrees. Kimberley, 0, reaching 18. The lowest temperature in the country is in Bloemfontein, minus 4, reaching 18 degrees. You can expect some sun and clouds. Richards Bay, 11.22. Pietermaritzburg, 7, rising to 19. A southwesterly wind of 30 kilometers per hour for Durban, with a temperature of 13, reaching 21. Mthatha, 0, with a high of 16 degrees. And then a couple of showers for East London, 8, rising to 18 degrees. Craddock, you're looking at 0, reaching 14 degrees today. Some high humidity for Port Elizabeth, 8, rising to 17. George, you're looking at a low of 8 and a high of 16 degrees. 16, your low is 2 with a high of 12. And then Cape Town, a low of 11 degrees, reaching 17 degrees. Worcester, 8, 18. Springbok, a low of 4, reaching 20. Upington, a low of 2, reaching 21 degrees. So definitely a mixed bag of weather conditions today. Some really chilly conditions with some highs towards the later part of today. But definitely keep it locked to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. We'll make sure that you are updated with everything happening in the weather.
When I hear about cyber crimes and banking scams, it's scary to see just how prevalent it is here in South Africa. Now, SABRIC just launched its annual crime stats this week, and SABRIC CEO and very good friend of ours, Kalyani Pillay, is here to share what I would imagine are some chilling statistics, or maybe there are a few positives thrown in. And the modus operandi is that they've increased, and how we should be protecting ourselves is the positive side, because there are tools and ways that we can tackle it. Han, welcome back.
Thank you very much.
With the bad news, you always come. No, we play an absolutely vital role, I'm learning, because it's all about educating yourself, knowing what's going on. Is it a lot worse now? What is the prevalence of cyber crimes, especially here in South Africa?
Well, certainly we've seen some scary figures. We've seen some good ones as well, but let's talk about on the digital side. So on the digital side, on digital platforms, we've seen a very significant increase in the number of incidents we've had. Comparing 2017 with 2018, 75% increase, very, very significant. Wow. And in terms of the amounts of money lost, we saw a 4.9% increase in that. So while the percentage and the amount is low, it's still a big figure. And what we're finding is that on the banking app space, on the mobile banking, and on online banking, we've seen greater number of incidents, which is the 75%. And so, you know, it's all come about, Graham, as a result of the fact that there's no problem with the platform. So we haven't had the platform being impacted upon or compromised.
It's thank us. Goodness.
It's us. Absolutely. So unfortunately, we've seen on the different spaces people still responding to phishing emails, still responding to calls for phishing, you know, where the person purports to be somebody else or a bank, and they're providing information. We're seeing SIM swaps as well taking place. But again, very, very important. I think that the important thing is that bank customers need to know this. It's a simple thing. your bank will never call you and ask you to give them your username, your password, your expiry date, your CVV number, the three numbers.
Any critical information that's used in a security space.
and with that information, being empowered with that information enables the criminals to go onto the different digital platforms and then compromise other people's bank accounts and spend their money.
Why is the penny not dropping, do you think? You know, it says to me if there's more crimes happening with less money, maybe that the crimes seem less vicious or a little more innocuous, smaller amounts, more frequently, maybe has a story to tell, but why?
I think it's more about people, psychologically, people think, gosh, the app is safe. So I don't need to take any precautions. It doesn't work like that. A risk lies with the banks, risk lies with you and I as individuals. The banks are closing all the gaps in terms of their side, they're constantly at it, but do you and I do the same? And that's where the problem is, unfortunately. And it's all about social engineering. You know, criminals are amazing at even psychology.
We've all been duped. I don't mean to do this in a judgmental way. I've been taken for a ride before a number of times and I'm pretty savvy.
So,
it happens to all of us, so get over that very quickly. Maybe some other areas that might lighten the mood, or are we seeing other increases?
We've seen card crime, obviously, still quite significantly high, 18% on credit card and 17.5% on debit card. But what we've seen on the violent crimes side, we've seen significant decreases. I think everybody knew about all the cash in transit heists last year.
Yeah.
We saw it going viral, videos.
Yeah.
So we've got a 22% decrease in the amount that's lost, and 22% in the number of incidents as well, so that's also
decreases.
And that's
literally lives being saved as well, which is great.
Yes, so that we're happy about that. We've seen, in terms of what we call associated robberies, that's where people are being robbed after they draw money either at an ATM or a bank branch, or when they're on their way to the bank to do a deposit. We've seen very significant 33% decrease in the number of incidents, and 22% down in terms of the amounts lost. So we're happy about that. We've seen a decrease in the attacks on our ATMs. This is the physical attacks on our ATMs. definitely some good news, but I think more importantly than anything else is for us to know that criminals will stop at nothing to get their hands on information of ours that they can use to compromise our bank accounts.
I think that's where we must leave it, to really reinforce that. It seems like when the cash is in our hand, we'll protect it, but when it's in the virtual space, when it's in that information phase, that's when it's most at risk. Thank you so much. Some positive news there. Thank you so much. On a human sense, and a lot of that says to me that the organizations that groups such as yourself are getting the message out there within the banking institutions, and part of the battle is being won.
Sure.
But I think now, guys, we know it is up to us, and unfortunately these crimes are a reality, and it seems to be all around us at the moment. That is the reality. So it's not just ATM card fraud, it is also on the online space. It is when our information is most at risk. That is extremely prevalent here in South Africa, and that's something that each one of us can do something about. So join us next week when SABRC CEO Kalyani joins us again to tell us how to avoid becoming a victim of ATM card swapping, which he has touched on before, but we'll delve a little deeper.
We are brave, innovative, everywhere. We are SABRC.
Don't you just love that we constantly just make sure that we're touched up and we're looking our absolute best, Palesa?
I mean, Leanne, for me, this is a very, very early morning, but it's essential to keep looking good, make sure that there's no shininess in my face.
Exactly.
So I'm using the Woolies Pressed Powder in the darker shade, one of the darker shades called Deep.
Okay.
And I love this for contouring, honey. I need my face to be sculpted, and Anel's doing such a great job because, honey, I need it. It's a bit early for me.
That's why we're so happy for it. But your Feel Good Breakfast Show will return right after this. Looking so good.
Get an insurance quote and stand a chance to win one of six Samsung S10 smartphones. Simply SMS the keyword LIFE to 31492 for a callback and quote, and you could be a winner.
Welcome back. You're live with Expresso. Thank you so much for tuning in as we welcome back JP Sebastian to broach what I assume will be one of the heavy hitters in this year's movie scene, Spider-Man Far From Home. Why? Because it's Marvel. Dude, set the scene.
Spider-Man Far From Home. So this is post the events of Avengers Endgame.
This was the spoiler for Avengers for a lot of people, I think.
The trailer actually warned people, don't watch this if you haven't seen Avengers. So this is after the trauma of that and not Tobey Maguire, not Andrew Garfield. I've totally forgotten the guy's
name. Tom Holland,
who is 2019 Spider-Man. I'm really old, as you can see. Just decides he needs a break and he needs to get away from the press asking him questions about it. But he makes some new friends, possibly enemies along the way. We'll find out, but have a look in the clip for yourself. Jake Gyllenhaal is Mysterio with Tom Holland and Samuel L. Jackson, whose name I can never forget.
This is Mr. Beck.
But you handled yourself well out there today. I saw what you did with the tower.
Thanks.
They were born in stable orbits within black holes, creatures formed from the primary elements, air, water, fire, earth. The science division had a technical name. We just called them elementals.
Versions of them exist across our mythologies.
Turns out the myths are real.
Like Thor. Thor was a myth, and now I study him in my physics class.
These myths are threats.
They first materialized on my Earth many years ago. I was part of the last battalion left trying to stop them. All we did was delay the inevitable.
The elementals are here now, attacking the same coordinates. Our satellites confirm it.
We have one mission. Kill it. And you're coming with us.
Mr. Fury, this all seems like big time. You know, huge superhero kind of stuff. And, I mean, I'm just a friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, sir.
Please, you've been to space.
Interesting cut there. Please, you've been to space.
I think you can guess what Samuel L. Jackson said.
Samuel, he's only got one way, dude. So, pros, cons, how do you feel about...
Let's tell you a bit more about the story. So, yes, he needs to get his head some fresh air. He needs to get out of the
murder, death, kill of Avengers.
Of Endgame. And goes on a school trip along with Zendaya, who is, he's MJ in this incarnation of Spider-Man. And what's really cute about the thing is that if you ever remember the feeling of going on a school trip and there's that girl you have a crush on and she's talking and some other dude is making her laugh and you're just watching from a distance like a dweeb. Like,
you ain't got no game.
It does that really, really sweetly and recaptures that feeling very well. So he's got a tango with that and saving the world, which seems, I don't know, kind of a...
So team rom-com tick, superhero tick.
Yeah, and so they tour Europe, Prague, Paris, etc., etc., Venice, as you just saw there, and on the way, Nick Fury, who is Samuel L. Jackson, of course, intercepts and goes, look, we got bigger fish to fry. We found this guy Mysterio, Jake Gyllenhaal, and he has, as you just saw in the clip, introduced these monsters, blah, 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 blah. I'm not going to describe to you what he just said. So the pros and the cons. Nick Fury is introduced here, and this is not a failing, but has absolutely no purpose whatsoever. He does nothing in the movie.
Continuity.
Yes, that's, maybe. That's literally it. And it's just so that, I don't know, your brain is tied to the fact that there's going to be an Avengers 4. It makes you believe that this is going to somehow impact that coming story in 2021 or whenever that is. The other character that's really important, and usually for Spider-Man, this character is New York City. He's constantly, like, you know, interacting with the people. Pedestrians are part of the character, and he has this almost messianic feeling of the city being on his shoulders. They go to another country, and that character is totally dead. It doesn't come into play. The place they're in is not made to feel lived as its own character. Not a major failing, but yes, New York, his neighborhood is hecka important to the friendly neighborhood Spider-Man.
While
it's lots of fun and it's got a lot of sort of sweet elements to it, it's kind of a popcorn movie is what people call this kind of thing.
Hey, we need more popcorn movies. But buddy, one thing that I'm really appreciating here is the suit.
Yes.
Which is a big part of taking on the Spider-Man mantle.
The new incarnation of, with every movie, like, I don't know, because they need to sell action figures, a new suit comes out. And so I'll tell you what, we've got a little bit of a clip where Tom Holland describes the excitement around introducing, this would be which Spider-Man is this, who knows, geez, 16. The 16 suit, why not, in the Spider-Man universe.
We start off in the Iron Spider suit.
That was amazing.
That was great.
Obviously, we have the Homecoming suit, which is very dear to my heart. I love that suit.
I forgot that I can't itch my face.
And then there's the stealth suit. which is my favorite suit because it's totally different and totally fresh. The idea behind the suit is Peter Parker doesn't want to be seen as Spider-Man in Europe.
Everyone's going to see my suit. Just get them out of here.
Let's go! So Nick Fury loans him this costume, something out of the S.H.I.E.L.D. Special Ops world.
How's the suit?
The suit's great. It's awesome. It's kind of Captain America-like with a Spider-Man twist.
Do you think that's Spider-Man?
No. It's like a European rip-off version of them. I was actually reading about him the other day. It's not him.
And it also looks pretty badass. So the black and red suit is like wearing a work of art. It looks so realistic that it feels like you should be able to climb walls and you should be able to shoot webs. And the way that it's made is an homage to the godfather of the MCU. The world needs the next Iron Man.
I can see the wheels turning there.
Yeah,
and homage.
So I've got four more nothings to talk about.
Yeah.
Nick Fury's nothing, doesn't do anything in the story. The place that they're in, far from home, don't make no difference. I sort of miss New York City in a way. The other nothing, Mysterio, is if you just Wikipedia search the dude, you know that in the comics he's considered the bad guy. So they've been really trying to hide in the trailers what his motivations are here. I can't give that to you clearly, but they really could have introduced another level to make it less obvious. So the movie's quite predictable in that way.
Okay.
The two other nothings I'm not going to get into because I've run out of time.
Give me a popcorn, man.
6 out of 10, strictly just a popcorn movie. It's not breaking the mold. And it's like cool. When you have a fuller episode in a series that's doing really good. It's usually not a bad thing necessarily. And fortunately, this one hasn't had a string of bad runs. It's just an okay movie in amongst good movies.
It's a cool movie. It's a cool movie. I can see that, man. It's a cool movie. No,
he gets paid more than me, so he gets to say.
6 popcorns is quite a lot from JP in this current movie season. We absolutely love it. It looks like some good entertainment, a good popcorn movie, which is maybe what we need at this time of the year, some light entertainment. We love Spider-Man.
It's just my arachnophobia.
Oh man, listen, yeah. I went to go and see it last night. It was really, really awesome. I was actually going to go and see Aladdin, and then I ran past and I saw that movie, changed it all around, went into the cinema, watched it in 4DX.
Yeah.
It is absolutely...
You got the full experience,
huh? It is
huh?
so much fun. It is really, really so much fun. And it's nice to see Jake Gyllenhaal play a different kind of a role for a change.
Like
he's
that.
Never played such a role before.
But how many popcorns?
Me? Yep. Just for Jake, I would give it 9.
I'll give it 5.
Also, wait for the post-credit scene. That's going to be interesting.
I'll give it 5. Mm-hmm.
Big or small, we've got it all. Everyone will find something at the Crazy Store. It's no wonder South Africa considers the Crazy Store the crazy fun place to shop.
Crack on the beat, boy.
I did what?
It's the crazy.
Mighty, but talk, I just do what he told me. I don't play with that little boss like you. I'm yellow bone and they treat me like emojis, okay? You know that I'm saucy. I'm a chick, so don't think that I'm cocky. Boss lady, don't think that I'm bossy. I will look 26 when I'm 40. I'm full of myself, cause it's toxic, yeah. I'm down to earth like Legacy, yeah. I'll be here forever, cause it's last, yeah. Crap up a buck, cause I'm fussy, yeah. So I get said, I get like a zook, yeah. I got the juice, get my dude, yeah. Why you people like it's stupid? I'm in the building, so no one is suited, yeah.
You get into by the money. I tell those people don't try me. I'm not the girl on the IG. I'm not the girl. It's my feel good breakfast show.
welcome back. We love you so much for joining us, just like we love the Proteas, who've had a torrid time at the 2019 ICC Cricket World Cup. But love them or hate them, it's down now to the last three of the four, at least. They have been confirmed. Australia, India and England, who seem to be coming back to some kind of form, have already advanced. And New Zealand will be waiting and watching very closely as Pakistan are still fighting for that spot, take on Bangladesh later today. Lots of permutations, a fantastic World Cup. Can I first just quickly pay homage to the bowlers at this World Cup? Because I think a lot of us feared that it was going to be like a David Warner batting kind of show. But the bowlers have been amazing. Mitchell Starc has been amazing. Bumrah has been amazing.
Berendorf.
We've seen something truly remarkable. So this has been a great World Cup, just not so much for us. So we walloped Sri Lanka.
Yes.
Will we wallop Australia? How are we feeling about this? Because I would imagine there are a lot of nerves there, because it's going to very much set the tone for what the Proteas have to deal with when they come back to South Africa and move on to test series and other things going on.
I don't think the Aussies are going to do us any favours.
No.
I think they're going to need to, for their own consistency, they're going to want to kick on. So there will be no sort of lessening of intensity from their side. And so short answer is, I think that the Aussies will probably win. They just are a little bit more settled. They're a whole lot focused.
Got balance.
And there's just a sort of an awesomeness about the team. They've got a potent batting lineup that knows how to score your sort of 100-plus opening partnerships, which is something
pretty much that, what you need.
What you need. Yeah,
yeah, no, that's the tail of the tape for this one. The games, the dominance has been typified by two opening batsmen, or at least your top three doing something special.
Absolutely.
One of them getting a century is what it's all about. Can Australia go all the way, do you think?
I think they probably can. Can they win it? I don't know. I think that India, I mean, they lost just recently, and maybe there's a bit of a wobble there, but
maybe need something like that, a bit of a wake-up call.
Just a wake-up call, absolutely.
To stoke the furnace a bit.
And so I think that India still, for me, are the team that I favour to go all the way and take the trophy as well. So,
wow.
Yeah.
I don't know why we are kind of the perennial chokers, when New Zealand have actually won more World Cup matches than any other team in the world, and they have a way of imploding, as they did do against England.
Yeah.
Maybe dominated by a very good England performance as well, but they now have to just sit and watch.
Yeah, it's completely out of their hands.
Can Pakistan beat the Bangladesh that is emerging, that is becoming at the moment? We are seeing a team that is really hitting its straps.
Well, I mean, I think that Pakistan are going to do just that today. I think that they're going to beat Bangladesh. It's going to come down to net run rate, and so Pakistan will need to know that they will need to beat Bangladesh inside a certain number of overs, whatever that score is that they're going to be chasing or posting. They're going to have to do a quick job and get in and out as quickly as possible, sort of a hit-and-run kind of a sort of approach.
And from what we have seen from those batsmen, I mean, you want a class act, you want to see, get a lesson in batting. That, for me, what they've been able to do, but they're one of those teams that you just never know what you're going to get on the day.
Yeah.
So can we still call England kind of outside favoritishes? Because they, for me, are feeling like they've been tested. They've dealt with, obviously, the home press, which is so hectic.
Yeah.
Scrutiny that they get, but they are looking really good again, very well balanced.
You know, I think that we spoke about a bit of a wobble and a bit of a wake-up call. I think they've had theirs inside this tournament, and they've set themselves straight and they're back on track, and they've been very impressive in the last few games, no less that game against India. So I think that they would definitely be one of the teams that would contend for that final. Obviously, they're going to be in the semi-final, and they will put a lot of pressure on themselves. They will expect themselves to get through to the final. But I mean, we were talking about it earlier when we were talking about football. It's a one-game match, and it could be that you win or lose that semi-final on a misfield or on a drop catch or on just a four that gets snuck away through the slips, whatever it is, you know, it could be that close.
So we've established the key is obviously net run rate today.
Yeah.
Just one important match, three matches left, in fact, in these rounds. And India versus Sri Lanka means very little. South Africa versus Australia, it means a huge amount to me, but not a huge amount to the ICC Cricket World Cup. I'm going to be really interesting, though, to see how Australia take that game. I have this like vision of a foot on a face or a throat. Somehow that's the Australian mentality, but still plenty of action to enjoy in the ICC Cricket World Cup, and we are seeing some big guns performing. So for the neutral, it's going to be a spectacular set of semi-finals. Who will make it through, Pakistan or New Zealand? We'll find out today.
So we have given you clues every day this week of the island for the upcoming Tropica Island of Treasure. So it's been from Aruba, Bahamas, yeah, the Cayman Islands, Barbados, to Thailand and the Philippines. The guesses came through on social media and it's been absolutely incredible. Mm-hmm. However, ladies and gentlemen, this morning we can reveal to you that the island is none other than...
Hang on.
Drum roll, please.
The smooth adventure begins in Curacao, in the Caribbean, with our very own Katlego Maboy as the host. Now, Curacao is an island in the Southern Caribbean Sea and the Dutch Caribbean region. It's about 65 kilometers north of the Venezuelan coast.
Ooh,
and it is a constituent country of the Kingdom of Netherlands.
Oh, now, the best routing for South Africans, pleasure, my darling, to get to Curacao is flying with KLM, departing from Cape Town or Johannesburg, with one stop in Amsterdam and then through to Curacao.
Now, when the Tropica contestants land in this island, one of the most notable things about Curacao is the culture and the features, with buildings, styles that you'd find in Amsterdam, but the beautiful pastel shades that you'd find in Bukap here in Cape Town.
Giving me all the feels, all the feels. Now, the island also has a tropical and savanna climate with little rain and warm temperatures throughout the year. The perfect weather for the Tropica contestants to compete for the smooth prizes.
Look, I already have FOMO and you don't want to miss out. You don't want to be like me and have FOMO and miss out on going to this treasure in the Caribbean. Now, Curacao is a little piece of paradise with amazingly beautiful spots off a beaten track, exclusive beaches, rich wildlife, mysterious shipwrecks and caves.
It sounds so amazing! Now, you could feel the Curacao island spirit for yourself with winning smooth fame and fortune on the upcoming Tropica Island of Treasure, Curacao.
And we'll be revealing the celebrities that are going to be on this island soon. You at home could stand a chance of joining them in Curacao.
Entries will be open in August, so make sure you stay tuned for that and enjoy some Tropica while you're at it.
Cheers.
You're thirsty,
cheers,
girl.
We're about to break it down one more time with the First Lady of Motswako. Lily Cooper is here. Fifi Cooper is here to perform IG. I know a massive hit that so many people are dying to hear. You're going to get a private performance just in your lounge. And we're going to see the stylistic element of an unbelievable dancer as well. Amy is going to be providing the finishing touches. Take it away, ladies.
It's crack on the beat, boy.
Yeah, it's the greasy. You know me, where my deeper talk, I just do what he taught me. God, don't play with them little boys like it yours. I'm yellow bone and they treat me like emojis, okay. You know that I'm saucy, I'm a chick, so don't think that I'm cocky. Boss lady, don't think that I'm bossy. I will look 26 when I'm 40. I'm full of myself, got some toxic, yeah. I'm down to earth like gossip, yeah. I'll be here forever, got some lust, yeah. Crap up, baba, got some fuss, yeah. I get said, I get like I'm too, yeah. I got the juice, get my tooth in. Why you people acting stupid? I'm in the building, so no one let's soup they get.
Cause you get touched by the money. I tell those people, don't try me. I'm not the girl that IG.
I do what?
I'm not the girl that IG.
You got that to hit, keep on working hard. So you make it wet, get better, get sparkle. I am hot, so chela morajo. Don't care about you, take it like a net. I got the juice, take it like a net. On the road to the riches, get like a net. They say I'm a walk, you have a mess. Udra, you drop hard. They sleeping on me, get my trust. Get she be levant, tell I'm got classy. Gotta get jam, I keep a boom, fuck, again. I'm cool, but let's have it done.
I'll test these people, let them study now. They say I speak that like Ferraris now. This ain't Facebook, how you like it now?
Cause you get a touch by the money. I tell those people don't try me. I'm nothing on the IG.
I direct.
I'm nothing on the IG.
Dairy Milk shines a light on the generosity alive in each of us. Bring your old toys to any of the Cadbury Dairy Milk's pop-up little generosity shops in major centres this winter and receive a slab of Cadbury Dairy Milk chocolate. Get to Durban's Gateway Mall Little Generosity Shop from the 25th of June until the 8th of July with your toys, and let's inspire a little more Cadbury Dairy Milk goodness in the world.
Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3.
Absolutely. Now, last week, Knorr, in collaboration with WWF, launched a Future 50 Foods report where they revealed 50 foods where we should be eating more of today for a better tomorrow. Musa Kaiser went to investigate.
Do you know that every food choice that you make directly impacts the environment? And have you stopped to think what it is that you're eating and feeding your family? Perhaps it's time to start. I'm at the living room at the precinct of Maboneng in Johannesburg at the launch of the Knorr Future 50 Foods, where Knorr, together with WWF, will tell us about more foods that we should be eating, as well as showing us ways in which we can make them at home to impact positively on our health, as well as the environment.
According to a recent study by the United Nations Food and Agricultural Organization, the way we are growing and producing food is not only damaging the soil, but it's also polluting the air and causing deforestation. And this has devastating effects on the environment.
Karen, you're the marketing manager for Knorr. Tell us why today is so important.
The Knorr is really here today to present a report that we co-authored with the WWF, and it's called the Future 50 Foods Report. And this is about 50 foods that we've identified that can help shift the food system.
What are the three things that South Africa can do to ensure that we safekeep the future of South Africa?
The first thing you can do is go and find out which of the Future 50 foods are available in South Africa. Things like spinach and lentils are things that we eat already, but if we eat more of them, we can make a bigger difference. Step two is understand how easy it is to actually include it in your diet. So our role as Knorr is to make it risk-free, simple and delicious to try these foods. So join our website, have a look on what's for dinner, and go and find some easy ways to cook with these ingredients. And I think the third thing, which is almost the most important, is to start asking for these ingredients everywhere you go.
The Future 50 list includes 50 plant-based, nutritious, delicious, affordable foods that are better for the environment. Each has been selected based on its nutritional value, relative environmental impact, flavor, and potential accessibility and affordability.
Well, you're a professional dietitian with lots of knowledge on what to eat, right? What are some of the mistakes that we make with what we put into our trolleys?
I think a lot of mistakes is that people don't eat a lot of plants. We tend to eat bigger portions of meat, especially South Africans.
What are some of the plant-based foods that we can implement into our diet for lots of protein?
Plant-based proteins include a lot of beans, lentils, chickpeas, bambara nuts. You can also add seeds. You can also add nuts to your meal to add protein.
And what are the benefits of these plant-based foods?
So you will get fiber, you get proteins out of them, you also get vitamins and minerals. Also because they come in different colors, you benefit from the phytonutrients, which are those chemicals that have been shown to reduce inflammation, prevent cancer, and keep you healthy for a longer time.
Knorr believes that we all can and should play a part in changing the food we choose to grow, sell, cook, and eat. By making small changes to move to a wider variety of plant-based foods, we can all help shift and fix the global food system.
Chef, what is your role here today?
Around the Future 50 Foods is to show people how you can make and incorporate these into your everyday living and back into our food systems.
So where do we find these plant-based foods?
Once people know about them, then there will be more demand, which will create accessibility. Because if there's no demand, then the farmers are not growing them, then because people are not asking for them.
Many of the foods we do eat are resource intensive, meaning that they take more water and land to grow than other foods.
South Africa has 13% of land suitable for agriculture and limited water resources. So we need to farm responsibly to save our earth. So the message here is quite clear. What are some of the things that South Africans can do to ensure food security in South Africa?
But there are solutions, and you know, looking at responsible water management practices, trying to reduce food waste across South Africa, and then opportunities like this where you're getting people to diversify agriculture and diversify their diets is really, really critical. At the moment, food is the single biggest cause of biodiversity loss in the world. We've got to get people thinking about eating more plant-based protein as a result. It's not only good for the environment, but it's good for their own health as well. So if we can get those shifts going, then I think there's still a lot of hope and a lot of opportunity for us.
It's easier than you think to impact the environment and your health in a positive way. It literally just starts with what's on your plate. For recipe inspiration and to find out more about the Knorr Future 50 Foods, visit knorrwhatsfordinner.co.za.
That was inspiring, first of all, and quite revealing. Today we are making something very, very special with a very, very, very special guest, Chef Mokgadi Tsweng, who is joining us on the show to show us how to make a bambara nut curry. And we saw how important the bambara nut is for our food safety. It's one of those Future 50 foods. If you're not familiar with bambara nuts, don't worry, I've just tasted one. Chickpea 2.0, much better, much tastier, but very few of us know very little about this. So apart from its being part of the Future 50 Foods. Chef Mohadi is here to explain a little bit more about her lifelong relationship with this incredible food, but also why they are awesome and how we can use them in a delicious curry recipe. We've been making some amazing vegetable curries that have opened my eyes. First of all, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
You looked spectacular during that insert. You look even more spectacular now because you have brought me food.
Thanks.
And you're going to be creating something. You've got a very special relationship with the Bambara nut, which to the eye almost looks like a chickpea. It's like a chickpea with a little eye
exactly.
on it, actually. So first of all, what it's a nut, yes?
Yes, it's a nut, but it tastes more like a bean. Mm. Which is why you can cook with it, you can make it into savouries, you can make a bean curry with it. So I grew up eating these. My grandmother was a subsistence farmer, and she grew these and sold them. She grew them, cooked them, and sold them to sustain her and her family. So there's something very personal for me about Bambara nuts. I grew up eating them as a snack.
They are mainstream now.
Yeah, I mean, then we call them diklo, which is their...
Diklo?
Diklo, yes, which is their natural, their native name. So Bambara... Is I've just discovered that they're called Bambara nuts in English.
I love it. They both sound awesome and exciting. And I would imagine nutritionally, looking at the amount of hype around them, they pack quite a punch. What are some of the nutritional benefits?
They do. They're packed with potassium, zinc, iron, and fiber. So it's like a perfect food.
Gluten-free.
Yes.
Gluten-free. And I would imagine once you start kind of breaking them down and using them in other dishes, we can start to see them replacing a lot of unhealthy,
exactly.
already expensive. And when I say expensive, I mean the cost implication, the carbon footprint implication, the water implication of a lot of other foods is the stuff we don't often see.
Exactly.
Okay, so the most important thing here is that it needs to become a delicious dish. That's great on its own. Having been cooked, I taste it when it's got quite a nice nutty flavor, which elevates it above the chickpea. But what are you making? And let's dive right in.
So I'm making a curry using the nuts. So I grew up on curries. My one grandmother was a cook, and she cooked a lot of, she was from Durban, so she cooked a lot of Indian curries. And for me, the Bambara nut is, like I said, a perfect example of how you can use beans to just extend your food and just to add spice and flavor to plant-based foods.
And extend your money. I think that's a big one. And I would imagine looking at the kind of neutral palette that it's going to be a great sounding board for great flavors. Okay, so right in.
To start, obviously, with my oil. So I use coconut oil because I just find that my body absorbs it better. And what I do then is that I start with cooking my spices. The reason for this is you want your spices to release their flavor.
Completely.
And this is the best way to get that to happen.
Activate them.
Yes. So you don't want, there's nothing worse than a curry where you can still taste the curry powder and it's just heavy.
The garam masala must have infused.
Exactly. It must infuse, and also I add my curry leaves. Curry leaves will impart that flavor also. And once that starts cooking, then I add my onions.
I love the fact you can hear the curry leaves popping the second you put them in there. That's awesome.
My onions, garlic, and ginger. So this basically, when you're making a curry, you want to start with your flavor pot. So you want to get all your flavors in, get it all together. And then only then add whatever meat or
and this also ensures that the smell of the curry is going to permeate the house for the maximum duration of time.
Nice. So you cook this down for a little bit and then you add your tomatoes. So here what I've done is I've just added 3 grated tomatoes.
So very finely chopped.
Finely chopped or grated.
Love that.
So as you can see, the tomatoes kind of like add that moisture to the spices and you just cook it down.
Oh man, it's just the layers. It's so funny. Within the last like 30 seconds, I've got the layer of flavor profiles from each stage kind of merging just in my olfactory senses.
Exactly. So with the curries, it's always layered flavors. You know, you don't want to rush anything. There's nothing more warming and loving like a smell of a good curry.
Completely.
And the taste of it. So you just let everything cook down. You mustn't be in a hurry when you're making a curry, but this one is a quick one because already our Bambara nuts, we've cooked them, we've pre-soaked them. My trick with the Bambara nuts is to pre-soak them overnight. That way when you cook them, it takes less to cook.
Cool.
And what I also do is I add a tablespoon of bicarbonate soda. Mm-hmm. And what that does is that it takes away that, you know, when you eat beans, you always get flatulent. And, yeah.
that is a hack. That's a life hack right there, not yes. just yeah. For this
so
particular
you,
dish.
You soak Great. Them overnight. I promise you, you won't get any flatulence.
That's a lot of people are like, thank you, Lord. Okay, so we've got about 40 seconds to wrap up yes. the menu. So the keyword here yeah. is knorr. If you yeah. would like to get this recipe sent to you, knorr to 33728. Now we introduce.
Now we add our potatoes.
And these, can you par cook the potatoes? Do you
yes,
want them to
you
cook
can definitely,
in the curry?
You want them to cook in the curry, and normally I'd cut them smaller. Nothing is more delicious than a potato in a curry.
It's gonna absorb all of those flavors.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then you add your nuts.
And you can, I mean, maybe play around with the dimensions that work for you, but
exactly.
You can see immediately how the flavors are coating us. The color of a curry is also, I think, very much what activates
exactly.
our metabolism when you
yes,
you know, the juices in the mouth start flowing. What is this?
This is the leftover water from the bambara nuts when we cook them, when we pre-cook them. So wow. you don't throw anything out. Food waste is a real problem in our kitchen. So you try and use everything.
Again, that's continuity right
exactly,
the way through.
Exactly.
And so I suppose whenever you're soaking or cooking something in water, you are drawing some of those nutrients
exactly.
out as well.
Exactly.
So
and this will add another layer, like depth of flavor to your curry. So you're not throwing anything away. And then again, we're going to use our stock, our knorr.
I love
vegetable
the little
stock.
The stock
they're so awesome because they're
man.
Like stock. As you know, it's not a powder. It's not a, you know, they just work so well.
I love that.
In this curry.
Stir in some real taste, I think, with the knorr vegetable stock pots. And it's not a powdered derivative.
No.
This is a real beautiful
so it's
stock
real,
that's been handcrafted.
Exactly.
Gluten-free as well, which I was amazed to find out about. Delicious mixture of ingredients simply melts into the cooking, bringing an irresistible depth of flavor. And we've heard about the layering of flavors, how important that is here, especially if you're pushing a vegetarian, a vegan,
yes.
even a meat dish.
Even a meat dish, exactly.
You need that layering. But this is opening my eyes to the whole world of pleasurable comfort yes. cooking that's available.
And the nice thing with the stock pots is that you don't need salt because they've got all that flavor in there. So you use little salt. And also, again, with our health,
looking
you
want to
try mm-hmm. and cut down on your salt intake. So
that's amazing. Then you leave it to cook until
you leave it to cook. And then just before you do, before you serve it, maybe 10 minutes before, you add your spinach. Spinach is also one of the top 50 future 50 yes foods. So we're gonna add our spinach in there.
I love this, how quickly this has all come together. The flavor profile is amazing.
Yes.
there's something very comforting about it, and it's absolutely popping with the eye now as well.
Yes.
Chef, thank you so much. This is absolute genius at work. Don't you dare stop. We've got a hungry crew now. The cameras have been moving
yes.
closer and closer.
Yes.
If you're tired of eating the same old thing every day, then the knorr Future 50 Foods list might just tickle your fancy, and you are going to be saving the planet along the way. You'll also find loads of unbelievable recipe inspiration that'll be good for you, good for the planet as well, and awesome for your family. To get your hands on the bambara nut curry, SMS the keyword knorr to 33728. Can I just hug you on behalf of
yes.
the entire planet and all families and all mamas out there that are wanting
yes.
to provide a delicious dish that's not going to break the bank? That's beautiful.
Thank you.
I'm going to have a little taste of our dandiya.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. Now, here I've got a question for you. Do you know what you put on your face in the morning? Well, Woolworths' Deshi Moodley and Janine Catlin joins us in studio this morning to chat about how exactly the vegan trend is impacting more than just foods, with a growing demand for natural beauty products, pushing brands to think outside of the box. Woolworths is on a journey to make a positive change in the world by driving the vegan lifestyle into the mainstream of South Africa with their recent announcement that its W Beauty ranges are 100% vegan. Now, we wanted to find out more and how we can make a difference with W Beauty for a more ethical lifestyle that is gentler on the earth. Please help me welcome my guests, Deshi and Janine. How are you, ladies?
Well, thank you.
I see that we've all gone black today. Very, very nice. I feel like we're flowing. This is wonderful. Yeah. I am so excited about this because Woolworths has had a very long-standing commitment to beauty without cruelty, and I think that this milestone of a 100% beauty brand is absolutely wonderful. Janine, how did we get to this point? Or shall we start with you, Deshi? How did we get to this point that you were able to take it away from just the food focus and say, you know what, we want to be able to make sure that what goes on our skin is going to be good for us too?
First of all, it's a very exciting milestone that we've just achieved. Yeah. We're 100% vegan friendly.
I love that.
So all our W Beauty products and Woolworths Beauty products have been endorsed and are being endorsed by an organization called Beauty Without Cruelty. Okay. They're an animal rights organization that also basically supports a vegan lifestyle.
Wow.
So it's a more compassionate lifestyle. And This milestone that we've achieved, we're very proud of as a brand. It has taken us a long time to get here because each and every single animal-derived ingredient that was previously used had to be substituted with one that was plant-based, which was sustainably sourced, and or synthetic ingredients that are environmentally friendly.
Yeah, I love that Woolworths is doing everything possible to tread more lightly on the earth, and I think that everyone can take a leaf out of that book. But let's talk about the ingredients used in this 100% W Beauty range. Vegan.
Vegan. So all of the plant-based or synthetic ingredients that are used are actually safer to use on the skin compared to animal or animal-derived ingredients. Now, we all know allergies created by beeswax. People are allergic to animal-derived or animal-derived ingredients. Yeah. So using vegan ingredients are actually much more safer to the skin. Yeah. It's much more kinder to the skin and kinder to the environment.
Yeah. Janine, what are your go-to products when it comes to the Woolworths Beauty range, things that are going to be gentler on the skin?
Well, gentler and beneficial.
Yes.
So we have some really great hero products that deliver incredible results as well as all the vegan benefits that Deshi's just mentioned.
Yeah.
In winter, it's really important to treat and pamper your skin. So an anti-aging moisturizer is a must to protect the skin and also to prepare the perfect canvas for makeup.
Yeah.
The Radiance Day Cream is suitable for most skin types and it has an SPF of 20 because sun protection is still important during winter. Yeah. Then once you've moisturized, if you apply your foundation, you can use your fingers, an egg blender, or a foundation brush. Our accessories range is also part of our vegan beauty offering.
That's amazing.
I'd recommend using the Longwear Max Cover Foundation.
Yes.
It's going to give you a flawless finish which will last all day, available in 22 shades to suit a vast spectrum of South African skin tones.
That's awesome.
Yeah, really great. Yeah. And buildable coverage so that you can go from medium to full depending on how you like to wear it.
Yeah.
For eyes, the gel eyeliner has a super soft, smudgy texture for that really quick, smoky eye, which you can finish off with a couple of coats of the 3-in-1 mascara, which delivers volume, length, and definition, all while treating your eyelashes kindly. And then finish off your entire makeup look with a slick of color on your lips from our Hydro Lips lipstick range. I'm wearing it in Lola. It's available in 30 shades.
Hello, Lola.
Hello, Lola. And it's really moisturizing and creamy, even though it has amazing staying power.
Yeah.
And then just to finish it off in the evening, just to treat your skin, we have a fantastic evening recovery facial oil. Really light, silky texture, absorbs quickly into the skin. and it can be used alone or layered underneath your night cream for a really intensive overnight moisturizing treatment. And it's a great quick cheat product to add to your foundation for an instant glow.
That is awesome. I wanted to ask you, why do you think it's so important for people to choose products like what is available with the Woolworths Beauty range, and why is going vegan important for not just vegans?
I think for everybody, if you are wanting to live some sort of socially conscious lifestyle, and all of us are getting increasingly concerned about the planet, vegan beauty is a really nice choice to make, to say that you're concerned about what goes into the environment, because beauty is one of the biggest polluters in the world. And it's, besides giving the great benefits, it lets you live that sort of sustainable lifestyle. It's good for you and it's good for the planet.
Well, thank you so much for looking after the planet while making sure that we look stylish every step of the way. Janine Deshi, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Leah.
Well, Woolworths is on a journey to make a very positive change in the world by looking after their people, the community, animals, and the planet. The transformation to 100% vegan beauty includes all W Beauty skincare and color cosmetics, as well as W Beauty's bath and body ranges, fragrances, nail polishes, cosmetic bags, and beauty accessories. These products are high quality, they last longer, while also being kinder to the environment. So when it comes to 100% vegan W Beauty, you'll buy better and also look and feel better as you go.
I'm loving it on every level of today's show, from our opening quote from Albert Einstein to everything that we prepared in the kitchen to what we're putting on our faces, how we are choosing to see the world and maybe grow the world. I'm loving this vegan influence in a way that kind of doesn't feel aloof or elitist, or it's, this is the way that we need to go. Regardless of what you think is right, this is what we are proving, this is the way we have to go. How are you feeling, man? You've been on, you've got 1 hour left.
I've got 1 hour left. I'm feeling kind of amazing. I feel like I'm already part of the furniture here on Expresso. I'm having the time of our life, and also being led by professionals. I mean, you're right,
who were you,
chill.
You're, who you're were right. You pointing at? Were you talking about Leanne? You were talking about Leanne.
I was speaking about Fifi Cooper, because I'm definitely looking forward to her performance a little later on in the show. But for
class
now, over
act.
To you. Class act, indeed. Over to you, Leanne.
Thank you so much, Pally. In your national news this morning, global environmental activist John Varty has offered to pay 1 million rand for the freedom of the Johannesburg Zoo elephants. The Department of Justice and Correctional Services says implementing full body scanners at prisons would assist in combating smuggling. On the international front, British Gambian Mansata Kurung is aiming to improve the quality of life for the estimated 4 million people across Africa living with dementia by means of a new virtual reality app, which can be downloaded to a cell phone. A new species of bee fly in Australia, Paramonovius Night King, has been named after Game of Thrones' villain, the Night King, because it thrives in winter, has a crown of spine-like hairs, and turns other insects into zombies. And finally, people are having a field day on social media after the Ukraine's health minister has suggested that swear words can be good for one's health, as using them can indicate good emotional contact between people. Dr. Ulana Suprin was commenting on a proposed new law being put forward to stop public figures from swearing in the media. The doctor added that people should work on removing their feelings of aggression rather than their obscene language. One politician wondered how Ukrainians would be able to talk about life in Ukraine if the anti-swearing law is passed. Others imagined a world where people could swear in dedicated spaces, or even introducing swearing rooms in offices. Wow, that should be interesting. Well, that was your 8 o'clock news update. Here's a final look at what's happening in the world of sport with Graham.
Some fantastic news from a South African perspective. Tennis greats Rafael Nadal and Roger Federer will make their way to Cape Town in 2020. They will be attempting to set a new world record for the most attendees at a tennis match. And that'll be held at Cape Town Stadium. Our own Trevor Noah might just be in attendance as well. Then a little further afield, the English Premier League club Chelsea have announced the appointment of former midfielder Frank Lampard as their new manager. That's on a 3-year deal after coach Maurizio Sarri left the club to take take charge, of course, of Italian champions Juventus. Then in our Cricket World Cup watch, the West Indies claimed their second win in the Cricket World Cup. It was after beating bottom of the table Afghanistan by 23 runs in Leeds. That happening last night. Today, it's a must-win fixture for Pakistan, and they have to do it fast if they want to progress to the semi-finals. They're up against Bangladesh. That game kicking off at 11:30 South African time. And that's a wrap of your sport ahead of the weekend.
Well, let's take a look at what's happening on the roads this morning, starting off with Gauteng at Bedford View. There has been an accident on the N12 eastbound after the Galulis interchange. Two lanes are currently obstructed and causing heavy delays. Now taking a look at the Western Cape in Lansdowne on the M5 northbound, there is congestion between Doncaster Road and the N2. The average travelling speed is 15 kilometres per hour with delays of up to 30 minutes. Looking at Metro Rail this morning on the Cape Flats line, there is an extended travel time of approximately 60 minutes on the Cape Flats line due to sets out of service, defective track circuits at Salt River / Wetton, and then also operational problems. So please be aware of that. Well, that's your traffic update. Let's get another look at what's happening in the weather.
So we've asked you to send in your sunrise pictures, and you've answered. Our very own Katlego Maboa sent us this incredible skyline all the way from Port Shepstone, where partly sunny conditions can be expected. Missing you, Kat. There are a couple of showers heading as well, but a maximum of around 20 degrees. So we've got you covered, bro. Then on to Polokwane, your low 6 going up to 23 degrees. Highest temperature in the country in Mbombela, 7 is your minimum, going up to 29 degrees. Today, Pretoria ranging between 4 and 22. Then clear skies for Johannesburg, but a chilly start. 2 degrees going up to only 19. Mahikeng, 3 degrees, your low going up to a high of 23. A cold start for Klerksdorp this morning, minus 1 degrees, but going up to a sunny 20. Kimberley ranging between 0 and 18. And the lowest temperature in the country seems to be this entire year. Bloem, minus 4 degrees is where you kicked off, going up to just 18 degrees. Richards Bay ranging between 11 and 22 degrees, with a bit of rain expected. Pietermaritzburg, your low 7, going up to 19 degrees, with a southwesterly wind of around 30 kilometers an hour. Durbs, you're ranging between 13 and 21 degrees, and Tata, 0 and just 16 degrees. Then showers expected for East London, your low 8, going up to 18 degrees. Craddock, very chilly start, 0, going up to only 14 degrees. And then a high humidity expected in Port Elizabeth, 8 degrees is your minimum, with a max of 17 degrees. George, ranging between 8 and 16. Sutherland, 2 degrees, your low, going up to just 12 degrees. The Mother City, moderate temperatures ranging between 11 and 17 degrees, but it'll be sunny out there. Worcester, your low 8, going up to 18 degrees. Springbok, 4 degrees is your minimum, going up to a max of 20. And Upington, chilly starts on 2, but you'll be rewarded with a nice high of 21 degrees and plenty of sunshine. And that's where we leave our weather today. Go out and make it a beautiful day, regardless of the weather.
Well, vegans, gather round, because this next recipe is for you. We are talking about naturally going vegan and definitely treading a lot lighter on the earth. And here to make us a very delicious, yummy, mouth-watering, meat-free meal is our very own Anel Potgieter. Anel, how good are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Especially now, yes, with this vegan dish.
I know.
It's so exciting.
Today we're making a plant-powered, yes, protein nuggets and cauliflower with gremolata oil.
Yes, with a gremolata.
I feel like this is something you could get in a very petite cuisine restaurant.
Look
gourmet.
At the final
it is
dish.
So gourmet.
Would you eat anything I like a totally. Meat dish if you can have that?
And look, not even feeling like I'm missing out on anything.
Exactly. Yeah.
Do you want to take us through,
yes,
the recipe?
Woolies has got this wonderful range now of vegan products.
Love.
And I'm going to use like a soy base, like a soy nugget,
okay,
that they've crumbed and seasoned. Mm. So the only thing you do, you put it a little bit of oil in your pan.
Yes.
And then you just fried for about 7-8 minutes. But if you don't want to do the oil thing, you can just put it in the oven and bake it at 180 degrees
as
well.
That's an option too. Yes, yes.
So while that are frying away, we've made earlier on already,
yeah,
the most delicious cauliflower puree,
yes,
with almond milk.
Oh, wow.
Can I ask you to taste this?
I will gladly
it's
taste.
It's so sweet and so delicious. It is divine.
Wow, it's beautiful.
Isn't
that beautiful?
Yeah. So that is just a bit of cauliflower,
stunning,
blitzed up, steamed cauliflower, blitzed up garlic and almond milk. The
stunning
almond just add that beautiful
and there's
sweetness.
Such a creaminess to it as well.
Yes.
I'm available for that.
Yes. So while that's frying,
yeah,
We've done that. We've also blanched some onions and caramelized, just like the bottoms down. Look how beautiful is that?
Stunning.
And smell it. You can taste it.
This is a taste and smell sensation right here.
And we did the same with the other pieces of cauliflower.
So it's cauliflower many ways.
Yes, many ways.
I love it.
And to add that extra zest, we're going to do a beautiful gremolata.
Okay.
Now, a gremolata is just like an Italian little sauce that you put on over your dishes, and it just lightens it up with beautiful, fresh flavor.
Beautiful.
So it's only a bit of parsley, bit of olive oil that you mix together. And I'm going to add some garlic.
Oh, yes, garlic for everything.
And I love Willy's packaging. You know, you don't have to chop the garlic. You can just like. So I'm going to mix that.
Yes.
And then for the zesty flavor, beautiful.
Oh, that is going to bring it to life so nicely.
And this brings every wintry dish to life. You can add this to soups, to any, like a stew. It will lighten up every dish.
Beautiful.
Okay. So that's happening there.
And our gremolata done and dusted.
Yeah.
Our nuggets are frying away there. We've got all of these other components. If you would love the keyword for this delicious, I'm going to give you the recipe again. Plant-powered protein nuggets and cauliflower with gremolata oil. All you have to do is SMS the keyword Woolworths to 33728. We will gladly send you the ingredients list and the link to the recipe. And you could be making this delicious vegan meal that looks like everything. Like, you're not missing out on a thing here.
I know.
I cannot wait to taste it.
What I've just decided this morning, I'm going to take like one day, I'm going to make my vegan day to help the animals
on
Earth.
Some really great details about that. What were you saying if we went vegan?
One person can save 200 animals a year.
What?
One person. If you go vegan, if you just eat
vegan.
I think
that's incredible.
I'm going to try and plate like a real chefy plate here. I'm going to try my best.
I love
so you've got
it.
Your cauliflower.
Yes.
I'm just going to add a few onions on it.
Okay.
Like that.
Beautiful.
And a bit of this.
Cauliflower.
Yeah, more cauliflower
texture. Cauliflower two ways.
Yeah. And these are gorgeous and beautifully, I think.
And they're so warm and they're going to be piping hot when they go on there.
Yep. Like so.
Once again, the keyword for this recipe, Woolworths. SMS that to 33728. We'll send you the ingredients list and the link to the recipe, and you could be making this and looking like a master chef yourself, because you've seen it. It's quick, it's easy, and oh so delicious. Look at that gremolata.
Look at this gremolata. Oh, it's going to change everything.
Loving it.
And then you add it up just with a bit of Woolies micro herbs. And there you have it. Isn't that just divine?
That is beautiful.
Yeah.
Well done. Thank you. And now,
pleasure.
Look at us eating healthily and treading lightly on the earth at the same time. Well done.
Thank you.
Boom boy.
Discover the new language of travel. Marriott Bonvoy. 30 hotel brands, endless experiences, rewards reimagined.
morning, South Africa. My name is Palisa Dembe, and that is right. I am guest presenting today throughout the morning, and I'm having a jaw of a time doing so. Now, on social media, we've been asking you, where would you go for an ideal weekend getaway? Listen, I'm in all my feels right now because I want to be exactly where you guys want to be. We've got Vanessa here saying, good morning. Hawaii, would so love to travel there for my birthday next year. Oh, that sounds incredible. A lovely getaway. Nomkosi saying, good morning, Expresso team. Good morning, Nomkosi. I'm taking it to the beach, Durban. Here I come. Wishing everyone a safe weekend. God bless. God bless you too. We've got Anthea Sparks here saying, good morning, Expresso family. My getaway would be to on a farm, having a hearty farm breakfast every morning, relaxing and just enjoying some peacefulness with a nice Daniel Steele book. Have an awesome weekend, y'all. That sounds incredible. Keep the comments coming in. I'm looking forward to engaging with you on social media. Let us know where your ideal getaway would be this weekend.
Thank you so much, Palesa. Now, I have a question for you. If money wasn't an option, I'm sure we'd all be traveling the world and not thinking twice about it. But unfortunately, that's not always the case. With flights, accommodation, car hire and daily expenses, traveling can rack up pretty quickly. However, that's all about to change for Nedbank cardholders. Exclusively available to Nedbank cardholders, you can now save up to 60% on your travels and cash in on some amazing travel packages. And here to tell us more about it is Mahen Tamana from Nedbank. Mahen, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Listen, you know, I know that we're in savings month, which is wonderful. There's a month dedicated to, you know, encouraging South Africans to save. I think one of the things that South Africans do always save towards is travel. How are you making travel easier for Nedbank cardholders?
Oh, sure. What we as Nedbank have done is we've gone out and we've partnered with some of the leading providers of travel,
wow,
both internationally and locally, and we've secured significant savings and discounts exclusive to our cardholders. Some of the partners we partner with are the likes of Emirates, Virgin Atlantic, Avis Car Hire, Sun International, AHA, Lodges, Etihad, and that's just to name a few. And all of them, as you've mentioned, offering up to 60% discount. I mean, that's a whopping up to 60% discount back exclusively to Nedbank clients.
So how exactly are these discounts redeemed?
So, you know, how, and I think the simplest way is to go to nedbanktravel.co.za. There you can browse all the offers, browse the deals, search availability and make your booking online.
Yeah.
Or if you want to speak to a person, contact one of our friendly agents and they'll assist you with that piece.
Yeah.
Who it's available to? It's available to all Nedbank clients, debit and credit card holders. There's no caps, no restrictions. It isn't a tiered discount structure. So what you see is what you get. You know, it's available immediately. So you could literally open up a Nedbank account today. Your first purchase could be on Nedbank Travel and you'd immediately have all of these discounts available to you.
Mahen, having just come from a European holiday myself, I now understand the importance of saving and the importance of having somebody that's going to provide discounts along the way because it can be expensive. Mm. Why is it so important for Nedbank to offer all of these amazing opportunities, specifically when it comes to travel?
So, you know, as a bank, we understand that for the majority of South Africans, travel is aspirational.
Mm-hmm.
Not just international travel, local travel as well. I mean, people, you talk about savings months, people save for a long time to have the opportunity to take their family on a holiday. And we know when that actually happens, you know, those memories can last a lifetime. So as a bank, if we are able to make that a little bit easier, make it more accessible, bring the country, bring the continent, bring the world a little closer to them, then that's absolutely what we'll try and do. And that's the intention of Nedbank Travel.
For those people who travel a lot and for those people who travel a lot for work specifically, is it worthwhile to switch to Nedbank in order to capitalize on these promotions and great deals?
I mean, absolutely. If you travel a lot, you could be saving thousands on your travel expenses, so you should switch. But even if you don't travel a lot, even if you're just thinking about traveling, these amazing deals and amazing offers, you just can't miss out on them, so you actually should switch to Nedbank.
Talking about people that are thinking, because I'm also thinking of traveling again. I know I just got back, but the girl's tired. She needs to travel. You apparently have a really interesting competition surrounding Mauritius.
Absolutely.
Okay, so, I'm officially paying attention. Yes.
So this is specifically for the month of July.
Yes.
Something exciting for Expresso viewers as well. We are giving away a trip for two to Mauritius, valued at 40,000 rand. I mean, that's an amazing prize.
Wow.
So it's actually open to Nedbank and non-Nedbank customers.
What?
All you have to do is go to netbanktravel.co.za, click on the Mauritius tab, enter your details, and you're in the competition. While you're there, go and check out the amazing deals. If you are a NetBank customer, you'll see you're a winner already, right? If you're not a NetBank customer, no worries. Click on one of our tabs, apply for one of our products, and as I said, you immediately qualify for those amazing discounts and value.
Mahen, you are giving us the travel feels. Everything has been absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much for being with us on the show today.
Thank you for having me.
Well, there you have it. If you are a NetBank cardholder and love traveling, and most importantly, love a good deal, then all you have to do is visit netbanktravel.co.za to view more offers and specials where you can save up to 60% on local and international travel. But for now, there is an even better part. NetBank is giving you the chance to win a trip for two to Mauritius worth 40,000 Rand. And all you have to do is visit netbanktravel.co.za and fill in the entry form and cross your lucky fingers. And the competition is open to NetBank cardholders and non-NetBank cardholders, so make sure that you enter. Do remember that T's and C's also apply. That's awesome.
Wow. First of all, I do need a holiday, but I have a feeling my MasterCard's going to take me to the Rugby World Cup. I just have this vibe, this feeling.
I know. I see you all the way in Hong Kong living your best rugby life.
I know that I can do this. I can do it, man. So I've been seeing the 021 Movement, one of our favorite dance crews here. They are spectacular, and they've got such a cool mindset about giving back and using dance as a developmental tool, and they're just awesome to watch as well. They're going to be closing out with a Friday dance. Have you ever experienced the Friday dance live?
I have, and it's my favorite part of the show on a Friday. So I'm stretched. I'm all stretched out, and I'm ready.
Can you dance? Are you like one of those truly gifted dancers?
First of all, Graham, I feel like coming from someone with two left feet.
I know. That's what I'm saying, because I can't, and that's what we're forced to do on the show every single day. I know. We'll see you in a moment. Start warming up.
Enjoy a moment in between with McAfee. See you after the break.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show on this Friday, having the time of my life as guest presenter here on Expresso. Now, what would you have done with a whopping 100,000 Rand grand prize to shop Manhattan style in Sandton City? Well, just last week, five lucky winners had the experience to shop a lifetime. Each of the winners of the Shop Manhattan competition had 100,000 Rand to shop for whatever they wanted. And trust me, they did just that. And we were there to capture all the fun and excitement on the day. Also, on hand to give some tips on shopping Manhattan style with some of South Africa's most popular personalities. Take a look, we had the time of our lives.
Enjoy full fruit flavor in Ceylon or green tea varieties of Manhattan iced tea, made with love by Clover.
For the past few months, we have been talking about the Shop Manhattan Style competition, where five lucky people could win a 100,000 Rand shopping experience right here at Sandton City, the home of trendy shopping. Well, the day has finally arrived. Our winners are here, and they are ready to shop till they drop. Let's get this started. Ready?
Steady shop!
Hi.
Gijs, my friend.
How's it, W2?
Good. You have been busy, 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 shopping, shopping, shopping. I mean, you have to tell me, what was your first reaction when you first heard that you had won this 100,000 rand shopping experience?
It was very excited.
Yeah.
I was very excited.
Yeah.
So, and I couldn't wait for the day. We were counting down the days until we got here.
Yeah. I hear that you're quite the keen fisherman. What do you think will be your best catch today?
I need a fridge and a freezer, actually. And we bought TVs, we're looking at the TVs, everything. So, yeah.
Every fisherman needs a fridge, but I know you're not doing it by yourself. Basi, you've been so busy all day running around with Gijs.
Uh-huh.
Tell me, if you had won this competition, what would you have bought?
I would have bought furniture. You know, my house, I wanted to be nice, I'd buy myself a fridge, a stove. Yeah.
You want to share your prize with her?
Yeah, please, Acher. Please, how? Hey, one, yeah. Please, yeah. Okay.
Ryan, nice life problems. You're shopping, very busy.
Tabish.
Nice. Who have you brought along to shop with you?
My wife.
Nice.
My daughter.
Yeah.
And my grandson.
Yeah.
And he's excited.
I can imagine. Who wouldn't be? I'm excited for you as well. Have you thought long and hard about all the things you want to buy today?
Definitely.
Mm.
I have a list.
Okay, let's go shop.
Yeah, no, definitely let's go shop. We're taking this TV here first. This one. Even this one too.
As an influencer, we get to work with a lot of cool brands, but then also the people that we influencing, I really appreciate it when brands come abroad and actually want to show the supporters some love. So I think it's such a dope initiative that the brand is actually including the people that follow us to be a part of this campaign. I think it's super awesome.
Preston, Centen City is the home of trendy shopping, and I'm sure that our winners weren't disappointed today.
Yes, indeed. I'm sure they had a shopping spree of note. Centen City just has so much to offer for every type of consumer, and it's the home of shopping, the home of lifestyle, the home of fun.
My word, Ashika, you've taken over the entire store. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Did you ever think that something like this would ever happen to you?
Never, ever.
Yeah. Well, I've seen you push around a trolley today packed. Which one of those shopping bags have you stashed Tando into?
Wow, so actually I had so much to do. It was so overwhelming. The rush of everything I lost along the way.
Tando, what a day. What a day.
I think you're looking for me. I'm the much shorter version.
You've made a return.
I'm the real version. You see, this is the non-shopping version.
Tando, you've had your work cut out for you right from the beginning. How did you keep yourself hydrated, baby girl?
I mean, hello. It's the only reason I'm still alive. Only reason. I think I've had 5 of these today.
I can totally feel the energy. The air is filled with Afro-cosmopolitan glamour. It is true international shopping with that South African flair. And of course, a Manhattan iced tea. It's day 2 of the Shop Manhattan style shopping spree in Sandton City. Let's see what the winners Asnath Mangena and Steve Mokolopo are up to.
Ready, steady, shop!
Phew, Asnath, you are getting kitted up. I'm so jealous. What have you enjoyed the most about this shopping experience?
I'm a bit overwhelmed, but I love the situation I'm in right now because I can shop anything I like.
But it must help that you've got Sarah here with you.
Yes, I got the legend of fashion, so it's kind of cool.
Sarah, I mean, it's been totally exciting. I've seen you really guiding her, taking her through the entire process. Are you finding this to be as exciting as it is for Asnath?
Of course. I mean, my first job was a personal shopper, so it's taking me right back to my first job memories. I must say, it's quite exciting. It's almost as if I'm shopping for myself. So I'm like going through this emotional journey with her, and she has quite a long shopping list, so.
Oh, that is Steve. What shop you are today?
Hey, tops.
Hey,
where in the man? Hey.
Yeah, no, let me not get out of here. This is the one. Now, tell me, I hear that you love spending time in the kitchen. Have you gone and got some kitchen goodies today?
I did. Pots, frying pans, you know?
Microwave.
Microwave. I'm one person who likes to fry in my house, chicken, eggs, fish.
And he also likes to work out to tone.
And work out after.
I can
beautiful,
see
beautiful
Kay. Let me speak to Kay for a bit. Kay, you are walking around with Uncle Steve the whole time. Have you had any standout moments with your experience with Ntate Steve today?
Yeah. He's precise. I love the fact that he knew exactly what he wanted. And he's very selfless. Personally, I would have bought a whole lot of gadgets. I mean, like a curved TV. But Ubaba was just like, I want to buy this. I want to get this for my wife. I want to get this for my family. And that element of softness that's really inspired me.
The highlight of today has definitely been how different people spend their money. I mean, some of the guys went into electronic stores and spent most of their money on like laptops and 65-inch TVs. And some of the guys went through to like fashion stores and bought maybe like a pair of shoes or whatever. So to see how different people strategize in spending their cash and just to see like the excitement and the happiness on people's face at the end of the day has really, really been the highlight for me.
There are so many happy faces here at Sandton City, and our Shop Manhattan style winners, they've certainly had a blast shopping. Thank you so much to Sandton City, and remember, dreams really can come true with Manhattan iced tea.
Enjoy full fruit flavor in Ceylon or green tea varieties of Manhattan iced tea, made with love by Clover.
Now, if you're the type of guy who likes a clean shave, you can get just that with Bic's Flex range of premium disposable razors. Add their Comfort Line shaving cream for sensitive skin, and the shaving process couldn't be easier. But this wasn't always the case. Now, a look back at history of shaving techniques before the days of safety razors reveals that there have been some pretty crazy and high maintenance shaving techniques. So today, we're going to find out just how far Graham would go for that shaved look that he's been enjoying so much. And to that end, we're going to be playing a game of beard or no beard. And this is how it works. I'm going to be reading out a scenario from the history of shaving, and Graham is going to tell me, under those circumstances, would he rather grow a beard or embrace them and stay beard free? Graham, are you ready?
I'm ready, man.
Friend?
I'm guessing we're going to start with like a rough rock. just basically scrape off. No, it's something. I love my history. I love kind of like the old school kind of fantasy period piece vibes. And I've often wondered, like, how did you get such a clean shave?
Exactly.
You take that katana to your face. How does it work?
So today it's kind of twofold, all right? So we're going to be giving you some great shaving techniques plus a little history lesson as well.
First up,
30,000 BC, ancient cave paintings depict clean shaven faces of men. Now, it is said that they used clamshells as tweezers to remove unwanted hair.
They plucked every hair out of their face.
Yes, in this case, beard or no beard.
Whoa, you see, I'm even just falling apart thinking
exactly.
about that. The bottom line is, as a caveman, okay, you've got to have a bit of street cred. Now, I would imagine that you get judged on how bushy and manly your beard is, so no. I maybe pluck an eyebrow or two with my clamshell tweezers, but there is no way on God's green earth that I'm plucking my beard out with a clamshell tweezer. No.
So based on that, 30,000 BC, Graham is not going to lose the beard. How about this one? In ancient Egypt, being clean shaven was a status symbol because it meant that you had enough free time and probably money to spend it shaving and that you could employ someone to shave you. Mirrors were not yet invented, so you couldn't do it yourself. Would you still shave if you had to employ someone full-time to do it for you, Graham? Beard or no beard?
I quite like the sound of that. I quite like the sound of someone.
Plus the status symbol,
Chavis,
darling.
I'm my beard guy coming. But it does make me a bit nervous that you don't get to see yourself after the fact. And you're
exactly.
Like, I don't know, you could have left stuff. You just never know. People are like, the whole day. No, I'd do it. I would go the route of a personal shaver.
Okay, Pharaoh. Mm-hmm. I love it. All right, how about this one? 50 BC in Rome, shaving cream contained goat's gallbladder, bat's blood, and powdered viper. Graham, beard or no beard?
Just purely out of curiosity to see if you would die or not after having a beard, I'd probably try it at least once.
Especially that viper on your skin.
No, but then you've got like, you know, the barbarians and the Romans weren't kind of gelling at that stage. You don't want to be running around with a barbarian's beard in
True
a Roman
story.
Kind of,
you know. Look, you'd be clean shaven, but I think you'd have massive skin problems. Yeah. So, hey.
Or dead. One of the two. You wouldn't
One
know.
One of the two. All right.
But I'd probably try that.
You're going to go for
a beard. He doesn't like a little gallbladder on the face, man.
I know. Okay, how about about this one. Around the year 1800, straight steel razors were the blade of choice. Ooh. Now, you had to rub the blade against a canvas or leather strap to remove corrosion before each shave. Since stainless steel would only be reinvented in 1913, Graham, in this case, beard or no beard?
I don't know. I don't like the idea of hepatitis or whatever else you can catch from, like,
oh, wow,
completely unhygienic blades. But I do like me a little cutthroat shave, I won't lie. And yeah, I like it when they go the traditional route as well. So I'd probably go...
You're going to go clean shaven.
Maybe have a bit of a moustache.
Okay, lovely stuff.
Curly moustache.
How about this one? Safety razors, as we know them today, were only invented in the late 1800s and popularized during World War I. Until then, if you wanted a clean shave and could not go to a barber, you had to shave yourself freehand with a sharp single blade razor. In this case, beard or no beard?
You know, I'd love to, unless someone else is doing it, I don't trust myself taking a sharp blade to my own face,
yeah,
unfortunately.
Yeah.
I'd probably rock a bit of a beard.
Okay, yeah, wonderful. Definitely a beard.
Oh, come on.
Come on, indeed. I think you...
I've already tried the Viper bladder.
Fascinating with those facts, though.
It's just so, we've got it good, man. We've got it good in this day.
Hallelujah. Well, that really puts things into perspective. Bic's premium disposable razors have made the world a much better place for all the men out there who enjoy a clean shave. Never again will you have to worry about rusted blades, clamshells, or powdered Viper. Wow. You can purchase your Bic Flex razor at leading local retailers and learn more about the product at za.bicworld.com. Remember that if you purchase any Bic Flex razor and WhatsApp a copy of your till slip to 082-255-3706, you could win a 1,000 Rand Superbalist voucher every day until the 12th of August. Terms and conditions can be found on expressoshow.com. That number again, 082-255-3706. Powdered Viper.
I would recommend the Flex 5. Go that route. So no one has to die. There's no gallbladder, nothing on your face. Also, thanks for the history lesson, sister.
Pleasure, darling. We'll be right back after this.
Master your look with Bic Flex.
Welcome back. Thank you so much for tuning in. It has been an awesome show. Thank you so much. You've played a big part in my enjoyment of the show. So cool to have your energy here. Absolutely.
I'm so glad to make your Friday.
Thank you. And it is a Friday.
It's just what I do.
Friday, baby.
Now, the entertainment industry must be one of the toughest industries to break through and make a name for yourself. And this is why, when it comes to young aspiring artists and performers, the right training and constant dedication to be the best you can be can set you apart from the rest. Now, the Max Shine On project shines a light on how aspiring artists can upskill themselves in the arts.
Hey
Achieving a career in the arts may be a dream for many and certainly not for the faint-hearted. More often than not, it will come down to persistence, passion, and dedication to your craft. We speak to Gemma Marinas from Stageworks on how young artists can upskill themselves to achieve their dreams.
A career in the performing arts entails you to be as multi-skilled as you possibly can. The industry is really unpredictable, and it's hard to keep that constant workflow coming in to be able to pay your rent and your car and all the things that you need to be able to do. So the more strings that you have to your bow, the better. So if you can learn to sing, dance, act, present, MC, create music, write your own stuff, you're in a much better position of being able to be in continual work.
Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers.
The biggest tip is knowing there are two certainties in the arts: uncertainty and rejection. Those are two things that every performing artist is going to face at some point in their career. So on our website, we've got an amazing podcast that talks about this and that assists parents in understanding the necessity, actually, of learning how to deal with rejections. Also, there is no one that is going to do this for you. You have to learn how to almost train yourself and upskill yourself and also look after your body and your mind, because it's in this industry. So being able to go to gym, make sure you're eating healthy, because if you're looking after yourself and you're looking after your body and you're looking after your mind, you're going to be more prepared when you go into this industry. Training is a fit. You need to find an establishment that works for you. And we've got some amazing training establishments in SA, aside from Stageworks. There's tons. There is some amazing tools on the internet where you can self-train as much as you can. So I think as well, understanding that you are in control of your training. You are in control of what you need as a performer. And doing as much as you possibly can in your own personal capacity is imperative.
My dream is to make people feel something through my music, and I also want to go on tour.
To make people happy.
I would really love to make an impact in the industry using performance art.
To inspire people. I would do that with my music.
Practice, tons of vocal training, always stretching.
I work very hard.
Motivation, self-drive.
To become the greatest of all time. I know it's a big title, but I'm aiming for that. And then my other dream is just to spread a message of treating people with love, respect, and kindness. We are the light
and we're gonna shine. It's through the MAC Shine On project that undiscovered young talent will be given the chance to let their light shine.
South Africa is a country with a lot of talented and aspirational youth, and we really hope that by showcasing individuals that have found their light and achieved success, that we can inspire others to do the same. MAC is a brand with really humble beginnings, and we're really about encouraging and inspiring ordinary people to believe in themselves and recognize that they too can achieve success. We really want to encourage young people that they too can achieve their dreams if they just with hard work, and we want to give them some opportunities to learn and grow.
The desire and ability to prove yourself are some of the few things young talent can do to set themselves apart.
Remaining disciplined and focused is a tough one, because we have ups and downs in the arts. We have times when we're doing really well and the work is coming in, and then we have times where we're at home and sitting and going, where's the phone call? Where are the auditions, right? So my words of advice is just to keep going. The journey is long and it doesn't happen immediately. The arts is a long journey. No matter how long the journey is, if you want it, keep going. If you want to see a
shooting star, no matter how big the dream is, your desire to shine starts with you. And with dedication and time, you could be on your way to the top before you know it.
Let it shine. Are you letting your light shine? Just let it shine.
Let it shine. Mm.
Do you think you're ready to let your light shine? Well, why not enter the MAC competition? Let this little light of mine competition let your light shine. And then let's take a little look at how exactly you can enter.
So do you think you can sing? Do you love performing? Well, here's your chance to do exactly that. MAC is inviting you to enter their This Little Light of Mine competition. And all you got to do is record your own rendition of This Little Light of Mine and WhatsApp it to 083-445-0547. The lucky winner will get a chance to produce their own MAC Shine On music video. So this is your opportunity. What are you waiting for? The competition closes on the 22nd of July 2019. Get entering. Come on.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
MAC works really hard on tough stains, so you don't have to worry.
Oh, gee! Didn't you say love always leaves a mark?
But it does.
And here, let the real you shine through.
So as we slowly move towards wrapping up the show, we cannot do so without one more performance from the Queen of Motswako, the First Lady of Motswako. She's an absolutely boss lady, and she is going to be bringing us one more performance. We're also joined by the 021 Movement, everybody. This is Zwagala. Enjoy.
Zwagala. Expresso show. Good morning. Boss lady. Zwagala. Zwagala. Kere ke chitle magay when I was gone wild. I got everything planned. Hey, so go away. Ito pata khana fanda. You caught with a better plan, be a better man, and you always gotta be aware. Man, tonight I'm trying to spend all these Mandela's too much, man. I think I need a rubber band. So long I can't, it says forget again. So long I want, it says forget again. Listen to what I kinda understand. Fit that no, but my job, but cover there. Man, we go party all day. Until I shut up to a lot of my babe. It's crazy how ready can I laugh off it, let about my babe. Sit on tip, I cost you not, grab a chupa wet. Feeling myself, I sung away, hey, sung away. I did but that hot ness, so please, hey, where's God? Little Zwagala, Zwagala, Zwagala. It's just a lame again when I was gone water. I got everything planned, everything planned. Sung away, sung away. With this and navigate it through the city backseat. Cooler box, got on a TDTDD. Now what did so we came hot off to my top, the party, we're about to party. Get go, get got it, get put my old lady, monte got it. Put my bote, got bote, my bro, mega monte. Having a good time for hot. Ain't nobody like an espresso party, cause an espresso party don't stop. And my movement too loud, and my pockets too loud. Get got ching ching, he go. So I got it. To push across to that, I would chop away. Feeling myself, I sung away. Hey, sung away. I did what the hotness, so please, hey, where's God? Go to Zwagala. Na Zwagala. Get shit to live again when I was gone wild. I got everything planned. I got everything planned. Sung away. Sung away. Get up at the Hana Fanda. Zwagala. Sung away. Sung away. Get up at the Hana Fanda.
Legend, movement legend, there legend. As well, closing up the Friday in the best way possible. But this is also pretty incredible. If you are a Nedbank cardholder and you love traveling, and most importantly, if you love a good deal, then visit nedbanktravel.co.za to view more offers and specials where you can save up to 60% on local and international travel.
So the best part, the good news, Nedbank is giving you the chance to win a trip for two to Mauritius with 40,000 Rand. All you got to do is visit nedbanktravel.co.za, fill in the entry form, and then cross your fingers.
Absolutely.
And hope.
Mm. Yep, the competition is open to Nedbank cardholders and non-Nedbank cardholders, so make sure you enter. Do remember that T's and C's apply.
What? Is everyone going to Mauritius? Is
Science reaches for the truth. It works for the big and small, for the old and young. And with knowledge as our first ingredient, science is at the heart of our food. For differences you can see, feel, and trust. It all starts with science.
I don't know what to say, really. 3 minutes till the biggest battle of our professional lives all comes down to today. Either we heal as a team or we're going to crumble.
One time for them praying on my downfall. Yeah. Two times for the homies in the chow hall. Wow. Three times for them on the internet. When they... Four times for them days that were all bad. Woo! Five times just went call back. Yeah. Six times for the kids like me who got ADHD just to...
Ben Jordan need a couple hearses. Woo! Double homicide, kill the beat, and a versus. Everybody living on the surface, but we came from the underground. Yeah, we deserve. What's beef? Beef is when you murder motherfucker from the beat. Kill them all, nah, nah, what's beef? Beef is brothers lying over shit that never mattered in the first place. Lying in the street, what's beef?
Whoa, turn the whole world to a crisis. Whoa, walk around the city with an ice pick. I've been paranoid, usually I ain't like this.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back to your feel good breakfast show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. We've been joined by the gorgeous Palesa the entire morning, and we didn't have her on the show and not find out how she loves to dip. Omar. Now, everyone has their favorite flavor of rusk, their favorite hot drink to enjoy it with, and their favorite dipping time. So we're going to get up close and personal and find out how Pali likes to have her Omar rusks. Yeah. Darling, first and foremost, have you enjoyed your time with us on the show?
I've had the time of my life. I couldn't think of a better way to kick off my weekend than with my feel-good breakfast family and, of course, everyone at home that is viewing.
Yay. It's been like seamless, eh? You've just kind of stepped in, been part of the family, been loving life.
We should kind of make this like a permanent thing. I don't know. How do you feel?
I think we're just going to try and poach you, child. Okay.
Let us know on social media. Would you like me back on your Feel Good Breakfast show every single morning from 6 a.m. to 9 a.m.? I mean, I see myself here. I see myself dipping and dunking it with
I'm
going
to go to Expresso Morning Show, SABC3, and say yes to that. All right. So, Palesa, we want to know from you, when it comes to rusks, okay, rusks, this is a very important part of our show. Our guests absolutely love it.
Yeah.
What is your favorite flavor of Omar rusks?
First of all, since I've started watching Expresso, I've been dying to share my thoughts on rusks. Yes. And finally I get the opportunity. Okay, I'm going to be simple, easy, straightforward. Buttermilk is the way to go.
The OG of rusks.
You're not alone. You know, a lot of people, that's what we grew up with.
Simplicity is a style that never goes out of, is a trend that never goes out of style.
So. And are you a coffee, tea, hot chocolate kind of girl when it comes to dipping?
All the above.
All of the above.
All the above. Okay. Obviously in the morning, definitely coffee. Yes. Midday, tea, some green tea, settle the stomach. But at night, hot chocolate girl.
Here's the beautiful thing, the cups.
I absolutely love, you can see I'm a morning... commute dip because...
So Omar Rusks have given us these cups and it gives you all of the different times. This has got the morning email
dip. Is that true? Are you an after-party dipper?
Pally's got the perfect cup, guys.
I really do. That's why it's so funny. I was going to say my favorite time to dip is at night when I'm going through my Instagram and everyone is spilling the tea. I'm spilling some hot tea. I'm definitely the after-party dip. How iconic. This is me.
This is me.
We've got
the bedtime. We've got the midnight snack. Oh,
yeah,
loving it.
And it's such a cool way of thinking about it because that for me, I mean, Omar rusks, we've been dipping them as part of our, it's like a DNA since as long as I can remember. A lot of mine are from kind of like the boarding school days, but it's a comfort food that you don't have to kind of go to a lot of trouble for, just take a break. Dip our Omar, get into it.
I mean, my Omar Rusk definitely remind me of my own Omar. May her soul rest in peace. Very nostalgic memories and feelings and emotions attached to an Omar. It goes beyond being just the rusk. It's a connection.
Exactly.
You're a tiny, okay? Let's be honest here. You're a gorgeous, tiny little thing. How many rusks can you eat in one sitting? And don't, we've all been honest.
Yeah,
I think... What do you say? It's always a safe space. This is a safe space.
I've said four, maybe five.
In how long?
In one sitting. So you can eke it out, but in one sitting.
Oh, my goodness. With that buttermilk? Mm. Oh, I can go in on five. Oh,
really?
Oh, I can go in one in one sitting?
For the rest of the week. I love it. Now I could honestly have this whole plate myself.
Yeah, this is yummy.
Well, we're not going to let you do that, Graham, because that's just rude. We would love to hear from you too. So let us know on social media when your favorite dipping time is and what you're dipping. And of course, if you have any photos, you can send them through to us. You might just make it onto our dipping wall of fame. Mm.
Why am I not there?
You will be.
You got me
You
there,
will
girl.
Be. We're going to take an epic, epic photo of you dipping right now.
This is the swirl dip, by the way. Mm. Swirly, swirly.
Mmm.
Anytime is dipping time.
As I am settling into all of the good food, we're about to have some more amazing entertainment. Obviously, leading us into the weekend is the dance crew, 021 movement. Guys, you ready?
Yeah.
Have you stretched? I saw you pop locking and dropping it. I'm ready. Take it away, guys.
I don't know what to say, really. 3 minutes till the biggest battle of our professional lives all comes down to today. Either we heal as a team, or we're gonna crumble.
One time for them praying on my downfall. Yeah. Two times for the homies in the chow hall. Whoa. Three times for them on the internet.
When
they 4 times for them days that were all bad. Woo. 5 times ain't call back. Yeah. 6 times for the kids like me who got ADHD. Just
been trying to need a couple hearses. Double homicide, kill the beat, and a versus. Everybody living on the surface, but we came from the underground. Yeah, we deserve. What's beef? Beef is when you murder motherfucker from the beat. Kill them all, nah, nah. What's beef? Beef is brothers lying over shit that never mattered in the first place. Lying in the street. What's beef?
Whoa, turn the whole world to a crisis. Whoa, walk around the city with an ice pick. I've been paranoid, usually I ain't like this. Ain't no telling how crazy I might get. Beat the police with a knife stick. In my whole life, I've been lifeless. Now I'm so fly, I'm a flight risk. Whoa.
According to the American Psychiatric Association,
I don't do the most, but I do a lot. I'ma make a toast, cause we still alive. No big. I feel like Pac. I shoot a shot. I'm coming in.
Wake them up. Inattentive behavior, impulsivity, hyperactivity, restlessness, trouble staying organized.
Could you possibly rewind and come again?
Hold up, hold my phone. They used to never want to hear us.
Can we ride it again? I want to see it again.
We'll get the back. We'll get the back again.
tried it.
That was awesome.
That was incredible. Wow. Goosebumps is what I'm feeling right now. Wow.
Oh, when you stood up, then I was like, I can't be sitting down for this. And I'm gonna, you had a front row seat. You had like a private. That's,
and you keep the seat because I know you take it.
No, well, look, there was a certain point where I thought Leanne was about to go join them. I'm telling you, you were right there.
Thank you so much. Itching.
Oh, the 0-1 movement. They are awesome. They are dynamic. Really, really cool crew. Thank you so much for joining us. That was awesome.
Halesa, my love, this has been a vibe today. I really, really loved having you on the show.
I loved being here. I'm actually feeling a little sad.
Don't we have another hour left? Can we go and just squeeze another little hour of the show?
I know. I had such a great time. Thank you so much for welcoming me so warmly onto the Expresso stage. Yes. Of course, I will be back a little later on SABC 3, so do join us. But yo, keep those comments coming in on social media. I'm loving the love.
Yeah, I mean, you work for a cool show. This is much better. Much more fun.
I love both. It's like saying, which child do you love more, Mom?
I'm being very cheeky and naughty.
We all know there's always a favorite child. It's okay, Palesa. You don't have to say it here. No, but thank you so much to the 0-1 movement.
We love him. We love you.
So much to our Expresso family for being with us every step of the way, every single day. We'll see you back on Monday, same time, same place. Have
love
a beautiful
too
weekend.
Much, too much, too much.
Expresso Morning Show, made with love by Clover.
Another feel good production.